folks. Welcome back to the Low Budget LCS. My name is LaChance, and I am joined tonight by Bigfoot.
Hello.
Now, let's set the stakes. Let's paint the picture. First of all, hello to all of you. Thank you so much for joining us tonight. I see Drosso. First of all, Drosmudge immediately, LaChance like Stows, seconds behind that, little robot man, of course, comes in, highlighted messages. LaChance like Stows, thank you guys. What's up, little dear Lilia? All right, here's what's up. It's a playoff match. There's like a million playoff matches that are happening tonight, but thank you so much for tuning in this one. Hell yeah, Less Force with the sub. Party bus, party bus, party bus. I'm assuming that is coming hot in from the massive party bus that is in the community channel right now. I can't remember a day since there's been so many people in the Low Budget LCS voice chat. There's like 30 people in community. So if you're tuning in, you're feeling a little bit lonely, you want to get one step closer to that community, join our Discord, jump into the community channel. There are a bunch of friendly people. I'd say 3/4 of them very, very, very friendly. Another fourth.
And 1/4 of them uncomfortably friendly.
That's true. And another fourth insatiably weird. But that.
And 1/6 of them are terrible at math, and it's just LaChance.
As soon as you said 1/6, I was like, fuck you, dude. What is, okay, there's 25% left. What would be 1/6?
No, there wasn't 25% left. You already went over.
Did I? No, I didn't.
You
I did three
quarters, and I said 1/4, which is the last quarter of the four quarters. And then you said 1/4
look at the
after
tapes.
That.
Look at the tapes. I want referees.
Yeah, look at the tape.
Fucking somebody
happened.
In chat tell us how many quarters there were.
It 100% happened.
Nah, dude, that doesn't sound right.
I filled up the circle, and then you started drawing another circle. That. And then I made a joke about you drawing a second circle, and you were like, oh no, I still have to finish the first
circle. You
don't
know what you're talking about, dude.
No.
It was five quarters? Fuck.
Yeah.
Fuck.
Yeah. And then what's six?
Damn it. Fuck.
Yes.
Son of a bitch. God damn it. All right. Well, there's some cool people in the community. Maybe not as many as I said there were. But there, some of them are there. All right, we are in draft already. Bigfoot, you definitely.
Yeah, I'm looking at it. I got my peepers on it.
Beautiful, beautiful. All right, we are in draft. This is again commercial playoffs. This is Revolution Resparked versus Serenity Esports Knights Templar. REV versus SKT. And first pick, Aurelion Sol, looking at a Wukong in response. Bigfoot, are you pouring that glass of whiskey or are you looking at this draft?
I'm looking at the draft. I already poured the glass of whiskey. Fun fact about when I was pouring the glass, it's in the other room and sometimes my headset doesn't reach that room. And you said, okay, the next time you hear me talk, we're live. And I went, okay, great. And I go to the other room to pour it. And I guess I didn't sometimes there's a little noise when I go out of range, but I didn't hear the noise. So I was like, boy, he's taking a really fucking long time to start talking, isn't he? And then I walked into the other room and you were in the middle of, and I'm joined by Bigfoot. I was like, hello.
Perfect timing. Perfect timing.
So I am looking at the draft. A large celestial dragon has been chosen to fight against very
so
small
big,
fairy
so
and
so
a normal sized monkey man. Yeah, I think we're seeing some pretty decent opening so far. I don't see anything wild and crazy. I'm not super familiar with these teams, so I think we'll start to see over the course of the series maybe what are pocket picks versus meta picks versus comfort picks.
The story will begin to play
yes,
out.
But I'm looking at a pretty, you know.
Now I see 8 Ounce Brilliant. Sweat Tea saying SKT Sense is my son. I taught him everything he knows.
It's one person playing five accounts. I would say, so on the one hand, it's for sure illegal, but on the other hand, it's such a handicap that I'm going to let it go.
I believe that's the ADC. That's the ADC here for...
I thought he was talking about the whole team.
You know what? Listen, maybe he's got five kids. Tell him how to play League.
Yes. Okay, great. Got it. Or her son.
Ooh, the fucking dinosaur onion's going to go crazy. All right, we're starting to see some picks coming out here. Aphelios, a champion I was never really truly able to master, matching up here with Braum in the bot lane, second round of draft of bans coming through.
Yeah. I also was never able to master it, mostly because it was very confusing to me on release, and then I didn't play ADC and decided that I didn't really need to learn it, and I never did.
Demonic Sombra, thank you so much for being the newest investor in the low-budget LCS. So happy to have you here. To highlight the different kinds of night Bigfoot and I are having. Bigfoot is having a glass of whiskey while I am eating my last Quaker apple cinnamon rice cake with a nice mug of water here. So you have two ends of a spectrum.
Yeah. I also just ate an entire pint of chocolate chip cookie dough ice cream.
I don't want to get too deep into this, but did you turn it into soup before you did? And what kind of whiskey are you drinking? Cavino Tokino wants to know.
Oh, it's not exciting. I'm like a real whiskey snob, and it's just Jameson. I got a free bottle from a friend who was moving, and
Is that Beans's Beans's
whiskey? he gave me a whole bottle.
That's
so
sweet.
I'm in between nice bottles of scotch, and I couldn't really bring myself to buy a bottle of scotch when I had an entire unopened bottle of whiskey in my home. So I'm just gonna work my way slowly through this one before I replace it. I don't dislike it, but it is not amazing.
Super reasonable. Gravitina says a soul first pick is but bold. Champ is good, but has large weaknesses. You'd have liked to see a more aggressive pick from SKT.
Fair enough. I agree. Anytime you're going to take something, unless something is like, so obviously you want to first pick a good champion, especially if that champion's a good champion that you are comfortable playing and fits in your sort of preferred playstyle. But mid lane has historically been a very risky position to first pick in because it's so exposed on the map that more than just the enemy mid laner counters it. And you kind of have to really plan around the kinds of champions you put around it and your playstyle. So first picking Aesol was, while Aesol's a strong champion, like they mentioned in chat, it is a vulnerability. It allows Serenity Knights Templar to pick an aggressive champion. And they picked Viktor, which is not the most aggressive champion. I'm assuming the Wukong's going to be jungle, though it could, I suppose, be flex top. It's going to be jungle.
Not with that Ornn pick. As Wingman says, a whole lot of scaling in this draft so far.
Yes.
Holy hell. This is play for late game, play for late game.
Yeah. The Vayne alone.
Oh, yeah. You got the Vayne, you got the Viktor, you got Ornn helping push those, past the normal limits. The Gangplank.
Yeah. Gangplank is
brilliant. Yeah, fucking
scaling. But yeah, Serenity Knights Templar does have the scaling advantage, I believe. I like the Braum pick. As well. It's interesting that so Braum occasionally has been used as a team counter to Ornn, right? When Braum is a strong support and when Ornn is meta, Braum gets extra value because you can use your shield to stop one of the halves of Ornn's ult.
Mm-hmm.
They picked Braum first, and then Serenity Knights Templar picked Ornn into it. They had the final pick. They had the ultimate counter, and they grabbed a champion that is not amazing into Braum. I don't actually know how the Gangplank Ornn matchup goes these days, but it's interesting that was the last thing they chose. They're gonna have a pretty vulnerable early game that I would imagine Rammus is going to want to take advantage of.
Yeah. Well, depending on who you think is going to take advantage of that or they're not going to, that wasn't a great transition. The predictions are live, and I've set it to a 10-minute timer. We're in the 10-minute meta now. I used to do it for 5 minutes. I don't know why. We're doing it for 10 minutes now. You got plenty of
time
to ruminate.
Doesn't 10 spill over into the beginning of the game?
I don't think so. I don't think about that much. I don't know. We'll see. Hey, you let me know if you think this is a mistake. But just, you know, bet if you're going to bet. Lesfor says the biggest Rev supporter of all time since 423. Hashtag Rev. All right, Lesfor, huge, huge Rev supporter. Lesfor, wonderful member of the low budget LCS community. Rescued, what's up? How's it going? 8 ounce sweet tea says, who is SKT's band? I haven't played in months. I don't know, man. I don't know what that means, but I wish you the best. All right, Bigfoot, you're looking at these compositions.
Yeah.
What tickles your tummy here? What do you think is going to play out? Who do you think's got the edge?
The thing that tickles my tummy most is how well Serenity Knights Templar scales. So a lot of the onus on this game is going to be on Rev to make something happen. Because if nothing happens, Serenity Knights Templar is thrilled. Mm. If this game goes 40 minutes without either team doing damage to the other team, Serenity Knights is going to be so happy. That's their dream. So all of the pressure to make something happen is going to be on Rev Resparked, which, especially in the first game of a series, when you're still sort of getting in a game speed and rhythm, is kind of tricky to do. They also, and the second part of this, is that don't have that many tools to make stuff happen. They have one engage tool in the Rammus, and Serenity Knights Templar has enough ways to deal with one engage tool between Lulu and Ornn and even Vayne's knockback. So I think I would give the edge here to Serenity Knights Templar just off of team composition, though Reverie Sparked has...
It's entirely possible that you just cut out.
Yeah. Oh, sorry. Yeah, I was fixing my headset. Reverie Sparked has some tools that can kind of do what they want to do, but I'm interested to see what their game plan looks like, because their win condition is, I guess, just beating Serenity Knights. I mean, they don't really seem like they have... I mean, they have some carries, but they're not, like, focused on a scaling composition. They have a decent composition to kite backwards, but, you know, then Rammus is kind of off theme, and they don't really have a ton of early game advantages. I mean, maybe Ophelios Braum is something they could try to snowball, or maybe Aesol with Rammus, but, you know, Lulu Vayne can play very safe if they want, and Victor, once he gets his first upgrade, can just clear a wave and stand under his turret. So it's all going to be on Rev Respark to make something happen, and that's what you need to keep an eye on if you're watching. If you're watching, you want to see specifically the ganks that 6th on Rammus is going to try to pull off, and then just the way that the laners are playing the lanes, and if they're able to get leads and push those. But Serenity Knights just wants to get a few items on everyone and a click through.
Just buy those items, fucking march her way down the lane and leave some bodies around while you're at it. I haven't seen Vayne in a hot second. I'm excited to see some Vayne play here. I like Lulu to protect him, but you know, pardon my French if this isn't true, but I just feel like I haven't been matched up against her a lot recently.
I haven't seen Vayne a lot recently either. And one thing that Rev also has going for them is that this isn't the greatest spot for Vayne. Someone who's really good at Vayne, especially when you have a Lulu and an Ornn item and stuff, like, whatever. Vayne is great in any spot if you're good at her. But in terms of the spots that you really want to play Vayne, there's not much of a front line of Rev Resparked. Braum can just sort of keep Vayne at bay, or Rammus, and then, you know, Gangplank and Aurelion Sol, even Ophelios to a degree, have burst potential. Lulu mitigates some of that, but this isn't really the greatest Vayne space. And you can see that it was, at the very least, their fifth option, right? Because they banned Caitlyn, and Reverie Sparked banned Twitch, Jinx, and Ashe.
Right.
So
it got pushed clearly down lane, potentially.
Sorry?
It got pushed down the line, potentially, for sure.
So there's always a chance that they had it in high prio and Reverie Spark just didn't end up banning it. They just, like, you know, wasted a couple of bans on a thing that they, you know, Serenity Knights wasn't going to pick anyway. But there's also a very real chance that Vayne is their fifth prio ADC.
Yeah, then, no, I definitely
see
that.
The person playing Vayne is getting hyped up a bit in the chat, though. So.
Dude, I mean, that's his dad right there. 8 ounce sweet tea. Came here to support their son. Oh, that's true. It's their parent, at the very least. 8 ounce sweet tea taught them everything that they know. And they're here in the stands today. If you look up, you can see them holding a nice sign. It says, SE Sense, I'm proud of you. Now, Cap Tradish is Sense's son. which means that Cap Traddish is the grandchild of 8-Ounce Sweet Tea. The whole family came out today. You don't play League. Do you play Dota? Do you play Smite? What do you play, Cap Traddish? That's made you the black sheep of your MOBA family. What's up, Moose? How's it going, man?
Solitaire.
Just solitaire.
Like, yeah. And not even on an electronic device with real cards.
That's. I feel like that's better. I feel for some reason I feel like.
I like playing solitaire with real cards.
Yeah. I feel like solitaire on a computer. Ah, solitaire's fine.
But then you don't get that.
That's true.
When you win in real life.
That is factually true.
You ever play Spider Solitaire? It was one of those games that came free on like Windows XP computers.
No. No, but this has me thinking about card games. You ever play Spit?
Oh, yeah.
Dude, I fucking love
Spit. Emily's really good at Spit. So is my sister.
I beat her in Spit the last time we played.
Yeah, my sister is so good at Spit.
Listen,
she's coming up for my birthday. That'll
oh,
I'll
really?
Add it, I'll add it as a featured show match.
Beautiful. Beautiful. Spit was so popular at my school. It's a fun game. It is a really, truly fun game. Gets you hyped, gets you activated. Gets the blood flowing.
I love Spider Solitaire.
All right. Classic black screen start. Egyptian Rat Screw is a game that has been...
That's a sex position. And
that is true as well. But it's talked about... I've heard it talked about a lot. I have no idea how to play it. But it's certainly gotten a lot of good press. All right. Distinguished guests, we are in for game one of Rev Resparked vs. Serenity Knights Templar. Round one match of the commercial playoffs, one of many that's going on right now. Lots of implications that will come out of the matches that we see tonight as people scramble to schedule their second round.
The winner of this series is going to play the Golden State Warriors in the next round of the commercial playoffs.
In basketball, which is the real crazy thing. We have a partnership. Yeah. Look at this, very cheeky ward over the wall. I love that. Knowledge is power. Power is money, money is time. So time a lot of time saved there by SKT.
The Banana Man. That's a good name. I hadn't really caught that. 97 Onions. Do you think he is someone born in 1997 and named himself Onions? Or
sentient
someone...
bag of onions. Final answer.
Oh. Wasn't on the table.
Sentient bag of onions. Final answer. 97 onions in a bag. It's alive. It plays League of Legends. Final answer.
You got it. You said the secret word. Congratulations.
Right. Yes. Cap Traddish says it's his daily diet. Terrifying. I just assume that Cap Traddish
I can smell
Captain
him through
Radish.
My screen.
That's true. I love onions. Onions are...
I love onions, too.
Absolutely fantastic. I put them on almost any... fitness influencers hate him because he eats 97 onions a day. But doctors love him because he keeps having to make doctor's appointments because he
eats. Well, no, 97 onions will keep the doctor away because they don't want to go anywhere near
that's
you.
That's true.
You
97 onions a day keeps the doctor
97
away.
97 onions keeps everyone away.
That's true. You will be safe.
I would like to make a note, and I hadn't noticed until this moment, but I am actually, turns out, rooting against Serenity Knights Templar as their top winner's name is Pickle Hater, and therefore we are...
Oh, I love Pickle Hater.
I've become mortal enemies.
I'm a big Pickle Hater fan. There are a lot of food-related
names.
We
are diametrically opposed.
What do we have here on Rev Resparked? This is the tangent people want, right? Rev Resparked, no food-related names on Rev Resparked.
That's not true.
I really...
I ate someone named Gabe one time.
All right, that was my bad. My bad. I forgot about that. Crempton is the 10th dentist. Vayne missing, or sorry, no, Aphelios missing an auto attack, I think, right there onto that
calculated
procced Lulu right there. Well, just, you know, buying time, letting them get away this time. but there's no guarantee that they'll get away in the future. A nice little, ooh, that disappeared pretty quick. There's a little bit of a gold advantage for Serenity Knights Esports. It was like 100, but that has disappeared rapidly. And it's almost switched sides now. I wonder where that's come from. But just some early normal laning so far. These teams know what they've drafted. They've both drafted at least a handful of champions that don't want to die and do want to gain as much gold as possible. So this is sort of just a lot of farming practice right here. We're gonna see who can farm more effectively. Get that gold. Ooh, a minion dematerializer being used by
somewhere. Animal Crossing commercial first round of the Animal Crossing playoffs.
I would 100% watch competitive Animal Crossing. I don't know if you're kidding, but I'm sure that exists. It probably
exists. Yeah, it's a horse racing.
I would also go to a horse race. I would go to the Kentucky Derby in a heartbeat.
Yeah, you get those hats. You wear the floppy
hat.
Get
a huge ass hat. That's true.
Biggest hat ever.
Big hats.
Doug Dimmadome hat.
Yes. Oh,
I want to go to the Kentucky Derby and dress up like Doug Dimmadome.
All right, seems like you and I have got plans in the future for whenever the Derby is. I don't know when.
You ever see that Snapchat picture of that guy who's dressed up as Doug Dimmadome for Halloween, and it's him in his mirror at his house about to go out, and he goes, I gotta
Ooh, victory slash in a little bit of trouble right here. Takes a lot of damage from the assassin tank mage Ornn.
Mage.
Here.
Yeah,
what other tags can you tack onto it? Oh my goodness. Kato. 1,000. Oh shit. Wait, hold on a second. A lot. Oh god. Wild Moose. Slide. Wait, was the Derby really yesterday, Skibby?
It was actually. Moose. I had an anecdote prepared and then I forgot.
Really quickly, congrats to the people with new subs here. Kato 1,000, Mixty, Doubt Spartan, JKL Dragon, Increase 78, Moose. You are too generous, as always. Appreciate the hell out of you, man. Does this mean you can special guest cast now? Actually, maybe later. We'll see. Captain, the real question is, how big are the caster's feet? Well, Bigfoot, how big are your feet?
The power of the scout's code.
You don't want to know.
They're too big, man.
Top secret. It's classified government.
Government won't let them talk about it.
Yeah.
The government sent him a letter. They said, please stop talking about it. Please.
I was like, but I want to. And they were like, no.
No, stop. Oh, you're okay. Done. Sure. Seven horses like, died? Oh, do I want to go to the Derby?
I saw that.
Fuck.
I got a news alert yesterday where it was like, blah, 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 wins the Kentucky Derby. I think it was Mage. I remembered because I like video games.
Right. And Mage. And
Mage stuck in my head. And then they were like, and seven other horses died.
Ooh,
and
I was like, recall Aurelion Soul CC'd right here. Rammus around the corner. Okay, no, just an almost attempt right there. Again, these teams are doing, both of these teams are following their plan to a T. And good on them. Look at this dragon take right here. It's not going to be Cloud Soul because this is the Cloud Dragon. So at least there will be a dragon that people are going to want to fight over. That is...
Yeah. I don't think they can do it. Yeah, they just kind of have to give it here. That was a really nice job from the mid and bot lanes to coordinate with Rammus. Aesol roams down. Aphelios and Braum shove their wave, crash into the turret as they all sort of converge on the dragon pit. And that's exactly what they want to do. They are a little stronger at this point in the game, especially with the kind of prio they had. So grabbing the neutrals is really important, especially since, honestly, at this point, for Serenity Knights Templar, everything's been going exactly as they want. They are super happy to not engage. They want to keep farming.
Yeah, I mean, both of Serenity Knights Templar and I think Rev, who do you think has the better late game when it comes down to it?
I mean, I think Serenity Knights Templar has the better late game. I think if Lulu wasn't in the picture, you could make a case that like a gangplank is always a threat to like one tap the Vayne, but having Lulu is so helpful.
Ooh, Victory Slash, hold on. Ornhorn being called right here. Pickle Hater going for it, but an immediate flash from Victory Slash. Oh, that was fun to say. Great escape there from the pirate up in the top lane. That was beautiful.
You know what they say about pirates.
Carry on. What did they say?
I was just saying that you know what they say about pirates.
Oh, that's fair.
That was just a declarative statement.
Cap Trotter says SKT is very late game focused. SKT snowballs very well. Proud of your elocution chance. Thank you so much. A little fight breaking out in the bot lane here. elocution, a great word to struggle to pronounce. It's like they put a, it was a test. They were like, yeah. Your elocution won't be good if you can't pronounce.
Like how Lisp has an S in it?
Yeah, that's fucked up, actually. And really dyslexia is kind of a nightmare to look at.
That's a really hard word to look at, yeah.
It is, yeah, absolutely. Vayne ulting right here, going to go in on Polston. That's going to be the shield coming out of Braum. They're going to try to fight right back there, but the Braum Q fucking misses. So far, so much for my elocution right here. Sense, weaving in these auto attacks.
It was actually a typo. They meant to say electrocution.
That's true. That's true.
Wow, that sounds like a man who's recently been shocked with 1,000
bolts. Great fight breaking out there. A really good read from Serenity. They had level 6. They say, we're going to pop our abilities. We're going to dive in, and we're going to start just aggressing as much as we can. And
now they get to assert themselves with vision, too. They pink up the river. They clear that dry bush. They get a little bit of pressure. Not bad. And you want... The matchup does become Lulu Vayne favored now because Braum is a melee support.
Right.
It is harder for him to deal with.
Fickle Hater with the knockup once again. Here we go. Look at this, though. Rift Herald being done at the same time. I don't know if these guys are going to interact with each other. They are caught in the Rift. Rift Herald pit right here.
Or no
Banana
ult.
Banana Man coming around. Victor in a choke point. Always good, but not when he's alone right now. Let's see. That's the Victor ult. Pirate ult has been dropped as well. Gangplank making a huge... Oh, hold on! That's great. It's going Pulse down! It. That's first blood! Beautiful! Like that's why I paused. I was like, wait, he's in the Gangplank ult. Can he get it? Now they're both trapped in this pit right here. Shelly getting these auto attacks off. That's a nice knockup from Pickle Hater going for the auto attack. Victory Slash quite low, but he's still going to live. Banana Man taken down by the dragon. Pickle Hater, is he next? Can he get a kill in return?
Oh, Rammus
gets that kill. 3 kills for Rev.
Disaster for Serenity Knights Templar, but what a happy moment for Rev. They pick up a neutral. They get a kill on their Gangplank. They get a kill on both solo laners and their jungler. They played that fight really well. It seemed like Serenity Knights just weren't on the same page. I couldn't really tell if they were maybe miscommunicating or if they just were trying to play the fight slow and didn't end up executing it the way that they intended to, but a free 3-0 puts them 2,500 gold ahead with a Rift Herald that they can use on plates for another few minutes.
Truly, truly a windfall for Revry Spark there. Another shout out to the party bus. Where an untold amount of people are in the community channel right now. Oh. If you're looking to hang and watch the stream, if you want to experience what chat is like, but audibly, check out the community channel in the LBLCS Discord.
Did I change the name
of Vega? Hello.
Temporarily as.
Did you with the what with who?
I'm gonna temporarily change the community channel.
Don't do it, dude. Don't do it. You're gonna forget. You're gonna forget to undo it.
Yeah, yeah. But then everyone.
No, dude. That's the whiskey talking. That's the whiskey. That's the whiskey. That's the whiskey talking.
Party bus talking.
God damn it. All right, it's party bus time. Look at this. Rift Herald play down here on the bot side. Plenty of plates to be picked up. Polston's going to be happy about this. Get some more Aphelios money in the bank. Very nice charge. Just able to get that third plate right there. And now, look at this. Perfect timing for another dragon. God, Gabe walking up. Just no fear. No fear from the dragon. No fear from the soul. Okay, dropping down some CC right there. Onions slowed by multiple sources. Lulu with the shield over the wall. Ornborn being called. This could be a massive knockup. That's going to be two members getting knocked up right there. And that is not the choke point that you want to be fighting Serenity Knights Templar in. 3 people down and a double kill for the Wukong. The fight continues. It is more of a rout. The dragon probably going to be picked up here as well. Oh, God.
Oh, that guy like does some
fatty fucking
now.
Q from Victory Slash here.
So the last minute and a half have set up exactly what we should be expecting for the rest of the game. The team fight, like Serenity Knights trying to pick team fights and choke points to get, you know, the most out of Victor and Vayne, while the carries of Serenity Knights should be very careful of Gangplank.
They absolutely should.
Ooh, you can't
oh my god, there it is! That's the fail, Victory Slash! Oh, wait a second! I'm wrong! Sorry, my mouth is full of an apple cinnamon Quaker oat.
Oh my god, he's right on the hair. Oh.
Holy shit.
Oh, I
that
think
was so close.
I would need to watch a replay. I think Gangplank canceled an auto.
You think Inkling canceled an auto?
I think he canceled his
brutal
pass.
Oh no, Victory Slash maybe in some trouble here. An auto is not going to be what he wants right now. Pickle Hater running up. Oh, just not able to get in range. Oh God.
That'll be the day where you almost caught Captain Victory Slash.
Wild Moose says it's not dyslexic, it's lesdixia. That's fucked up, dude. I'd love to hear some people's takes on how to pronounce that. Lesdexia.
Yeah. I think you got it.
Yeah, actually, that's pretty close.
Yeah.
So here's what's up. That was an insanely close escape by the Banana Man. Listen, he earned that nickname. All
yeah,
right?
I
think it's pretty
yeah.
obvious why.
Because he's so slippery like a banana peel?
Because he's so slippery like a banana peel. Exactly.
Was that what you were getting at?
Let's Dexia. Ooh, Vega. Let's Dexia. I like that.
What yes, about Sexlexia?
It was
That's
sex,
where you can...
Sexlexia.
You think you
have
a hard
time... Banana Man may be in some trouble. Let's see if he can escape again. But no, two miracles might be too many. Let's see. Can he get a kill in
no,
response
no,
right
no,
there?
Way,
That's
no,
actually
way.
A lot of damage. Hold on. Gravity Field doing a lot right here. Oh, my God. He did it again. He's so slippery. He's a living banana peel. Holy shit. That's amazing.
You
oh
know
my God!
Before they play a game, they have these rituals. They're like, "Oh, I always eat grilled chicken before a game," or like, "Oh, I always tie my left shoe before my right shoe."
Oh!
Banana Man covers himself in banana peels.
Dude, he's fully wearing only banana peels. Ornhorn being called right here. Pickle Hater does hit it. There we go. That's gonna be the knockup. Victory Slash Ooh. Though, healing through this, getting these auto attacks. He's deciding he wants to stay. He's not gonna run. One more auto attack's gonna do. It's gonna come down to the wire. That's gonna be Ornn getting the kill right there up in the top lane.
Close.
Beautiful. Holy shit.
Close.
I am loving this narrative of Pickle Hater, or sorry, not of Pickle Hater, of the Banana Man as an escape artist. That is insane. That is, that was a caster curse in full effect right there. I think yeah. I said,
he can't get away with it twice.
Two miracles is too many. Yeah. And then he
Friends
escaped
that's enough.
Right
yeah.
away. God damn.
Yeah.
Incredible. Yes, the Looney Tunes sounds effect every time he escapes. I should have had that if I was smart. I don't have that. I have this cheer. I have a record scratch. I've got a car revving up.
Oh, was I supposed to? I forgot I can't hear those.
No,
like,
don't worry about it. I'm not.
You said them as if you were playing them, and I was like.
I was.
Yeah,
I was.
And I've got a car.
You were about to. As if it was a bit. I would not have been able to back you up on that bit. My apologies.
Okay.
So there have been some punctuated moments of action in this game. Both teams committed to scaling, but certainly not shying away from fighting. Gold,
yep.
still pretty yep. close.
Yeah,
where,
sure.
Where? Who is this? Who's broken into our channel?
There's requests from the people, community. Oh,
God damn it! It's from the people. All right. Well, we bend our knee to the people. What is it?
I do
what
not.
Do they want? Oh, he left. Okay. All right, well, come back on and let us know what the people want when you come back on.
Captain Radish asking the important questions. What is Bigfoot's whiskey of choice? My favorite scotch ever is Lagavulin. I like really peaty single malts. For its money, I usually get Laphroaig, which is very peaty in the same fashion, but about $30, $40 cheaper a bottle.
the people wanted to
recommend...
see the gold for the players, 100%.
Yeah.
Toggling
yeah.
over for the gold.
Honestly, fairly even. The biggest lead
Look
is on the
gank. Look at this gank, though.
Yeah.
Here it is. Ram is coming around as well. The coordination, all the big circle ults being dropped, planets being dropped as well. That's going to be a kill onto Cobra Strike right there. Beautiful, beautiful play. And
you know,
just
Cobra
in time for
the
dragon. That is the coordination that you need. Beautiful, beautiful, beautiful play. They're going to be able to get Dragon off the back of that for sure.
Yeah. Cobra Strike forgot to put on the banana peels for the game.
That's
he is,
true.
He is not covered
Notably,
in a single
double
banana
man. Hold on. It's the gank again.
Oh, the Herald, though.
One more auto.
Ooh, okay, the minions? No. Are they? No. It did pull them off of Dragon for a little bit, so now they have to decide if they're going to trade Dragon for the mid turret, and it looks like.
Wukong walks up.
At all. Never mind.
Beautiful.
Wukong has made the decision for them.
Beautiful. Excellent. Vino Tokino, a fan of Highland Scotch's teleport coming in. Hold on. I don't think the decision is so clear-cut anymore. Piccolo Hater on the other end of this. Is the Ornhorn up? It absolutely is. He can pull the trigger whenever he wants. Maybe waiting for them to get to a choke point. Absolutely what's happening. Braum as well. The shield goes down. And once again, this is the Templars finding success in a choke point. Another slew of kills for them. And this time, a double kill for a triple kill for Da Banana Man.
This may be the beginning of the end. If Victor is able to pick up this much gold on a team fight, they're going to get the dragon. They're going to start scaling. I know they're technically down gold, but I would say they're very up in momentum. They're now up in neutrals. They are where they want to be.
Absolutely. Big moral victories for them. Fireball is Moose's whiskey of choice. I'm right there with you, Moose.
Oh. The first time me and LeChance ever met. How we became friends. You showed up to our apartment in college with a bottle of Fireball and said, "Who wants to drink this to me?" And I hate Fireball. And something in me said, "I will."
And then we had an adventure.
And then we had, and here we are.
And here we are now, like 10 years later.
Yeah.
Ohai Vega saying this game comes down to GP's impact late. He's getting massive solo gold in a side lane, but hasn't had an impact yet. Astute observation. The man is wealthy as fuck. Richest guy in the game right now.
Yeah, that's what I was kind of alluding to before, right? Like, Vayne and Victor only scale to the point where they are still alive. Mm-hmm. So, Gangplank's job is going to be to try to absolutely explode one of them. The only downside to that is that Lulu acts like a very good deterrent for one-shotting a carry. So, it's part of the onus is on the Gangplank to pop them, but the main responsibility in that situation is for Lulu to save them. So if everyone, basically what I'm trying to say is if everyone in the situation is playing perfectly, Vayne and Victor are going to run over the enemy team in a team fight. But there's no guarantee that everyone's going to play perfectly. So there still is the hope that Rev needs to hang on to is that Gangplank can blow up the two main damage sources of Serenity Knights.
Definitely. Definitely. It's gonna come down to these barrel chains. Just finding the angles. I mean, look at that. They're starting to do some damage. It is just one of those scary chances.
Oh.
Great gank down here. Three miracles is way too many. Da Banana Man has no chance. Okay, alright, so he's not immortal. That's good to know.
Look, banana peels are only so slippery.
Right. That was,
if you run an entire army
once,
over a banana peel, a couple might trip.
But... Right.
A bunch you're not gonna.
Wait, did GP get that kill?
Again?
Was that a kill from
downtown?
From his ult?
I don't...
It may have been.
It may have been. I can check. It was. You can hover over the little line
Hot
in the timeline.
Damn.
That's huge. That's enormous.
GP kill steal for sure. Vision.
But that's a tactical kill steal.
That was a
that's
tactical.
That's not trolling.
Yeah.
You want your golden. You 100%. Gotta put your eggs in that basket.
Right. They're doing the right thing. Victory knows that he's a big victory condition for the team right here, although maybe in a lot of trouble. 97 onions, a bag of sentient onions going forward, auto-attacking this Gangplank right here, dealing a lot of damage, maybe deciding if he's going to go in any further. Ornhorn getting called, he's going to toss it out, doesn't make a connection. Another teleport coming in as well, because, wow, Aurelion Soul trying to engage on these
guys.
You
got a party bus up here.
You do. Wukong never ulted during that. It's up now. I don't know if it was down while he was attacking them.
I wonder. They can't possibly be fighting over Baron here.
Not Cobra.
This is much too early.
Oh, interesting. You're damn right, big dog. You
know that it's
absolutely
Koba?
Absolutely right. It's Koba. I didn't see that.
I decided
that
to keep
all.
Calling it. I decided to go lean into the Cobra because it.
I believed with every
ounce of my
soul.
I've never seen a Koba
that it was,
strike, but
it was
I've seen
Koba.
A Koba strike.
I was never. What series was that? That was G.I. Joe?
What? Oh, isn't that like Cobra Force or something?
No. The Listexia strikes again. Doesn't it always? Captain Rabbit.
Let's see. Let me look up Cobra.
Gotta
strike.
Be. Gotta be a real thing. Cobra Commander. Yeah.
Cobra Strike
but
is
he struck people, certainly.
Joe, G.I. Joe Cobra Strike was a video game for the Atari 2600.
That's definitely, surely that's what the reference is, an Atari video
it's
game.
It's just called Cobra. They're all the right. fictional terrorist organization.
Well, who knows? Maybe.
Maybe they're real?
Maybe they're real. It's possible.
Or maybe they're the good guys.
Or, hold on, think about this one.
I do like it. It's like, they're a fictional terrorist organization. Well,
back in my day, we would play all the time.
I'm sorry.
We're in Minecraft, God. Never got into Minecraft either. That just, I think, showed up a little bit too late for me.
It showed up too...
I was playing other games. Look at this. Definitely a fight breaking out right here. Another choke point.
Good
God,
flashes.
The Knights Templars just have a sixth sense for when Rev Resparked is walking into a choke point. They know it. They love it. They want to have it. They are 3-4K down in this fight, even though they might feel like they have momentum. Look at Gangplank. He is just marching through a teleport coming. This is going to be a 5v5. Picklehead on the inside. Front lines starting to be drawn up. Lines starting to form here. Some CCB and drop. Cobra Strike taking a lot of damage right there. Off the Braum passive, off the Aphelios Q as well.
GP should drop an ult.
Wukong going around. He's going for a flank right here, but Aurelion's still dealing so much damage. Are they taking too much time? That's going to be a Gangplank hold. Wukong into the back line, but the rest of his team's not there. They can't follow it up with the damage. They're starting to get there. That's Braum getting taken down. Ornhorn knocking up quite a few of them. Oh my god, that's a planet being dropped on them. Such low health bars. The Banana Man flies. Holy shit! Gangplank on a tear right now. A double kill for the Ornn right here, but if they can kill the Gangplank, maybe they can win this fight, but that's going to be Cobra Strike going down. Whoa. That's going to be a double kill and snatched out of the jaws of defeat. That is a victory for Rev Resparked and the Dragon as well.
Such a well-played team fight from them. That's enormous. They're going to pick up a second Dragon, and all of a sudden this game where everyone thought that, myself included, that Serenity Knights Templar is just going to scale through as the game goes later. Well, we're at 25 minutes, and it is, not only are they not even, they're down 4K and lost that fight pretty handily to the carries of Rev.
Dude, there is a point in that where I think it was like a Prowler's Claw into a kill from Gangplank into a Q that got him another kill, like right there.
Yeah.
Like the numbers
slash.
Shifted super fast in that fight.
Yeah.
That was wild. And Aurelion Soul as well.
Managing to live. Yeah, he positioned very well through that whole fight.
Absolutely. When I'm calling that fight, I'm thinking like, Gangplank is the main character here. If you can kill him, you can win the fight. And then I look over, I was like, oh, there's one other person who's still in this fight. Who is that? Oh, it's Aurelion Soul.
Oh, right. It's the other massive source of damage.
Shoot, these guys, they live. And Braum was killed relatively early in that fight. That was really solid positioning from Rev Resparked. And now we're just looking down the barrel of a 5K gold lead.
I'm so curious what SKT wants to do next. Because it's hard in these situations. Because in my mind, objectively, the right call is to just get gold, right? Mm. You don't have to...
Look at this. Hold on right here. 97 Onions being taunted right here. That's a massive Braum ult. The planet being dropped as well. The tides have turned. Now it is Serenity Knights Templar who's got it. Oh, look at the 1v1 down here. The Banana Man killing Gangplank in a 1v1. Okay, that's a good sign. The rest of his team says, hey, let's just get the fuck out of here. We got to win on the other side of the map. No need to keep this fight going if we don't have to.
So even trades are really good for SKT because they are the scaling team. Again, we've seen in other fights that depending on how you play the fight, that doesn't really matter. But objectively, a scaling team is happy with trades when they're down in the mid game. I am interested to see what other kinds of macro decisions they make, because a team who has lost a couple of fights and might feel like they're on the back foot might feel pressure to be proactive. Where in reality, I think the right answer is to just keep farming. Mm-hmm. They are not in danger of losing soul. If they're smart and they are warding well, they're not in danger of losing Baron.
Right.
Because they have, you know, it's not like they're going to be able
what
to
do you think about a Baron rush?
Baron.
They're going to start it? They're starting it. Banana Man on it right now. Lots of people adjust back, but notably Rammus is up here. Aurelion Soul starting to go over as well. They've got a Vayne. Teleport coming in right here. Baron
it's
down to roughly half
fast,
health.
Though.
Rammus going out of the backside. Looped up with that Aurelion Soul. Fight maybe starting. The Banana Man finding himself on the front line right here. He's taunted. He's in a lot of trouble with Aurelion Soul dealing damage to him, but he goes golden. Hold on. Planet drops, but the Goddamn, fuck that name. It's so good, though. Victor does fall in the end right there. Pickle here now finding himself in a 4v1. Not a person has fallen on the side of Rev, and for good reason. They've got the damage. They've got the positioning, and that is going to be a 4 yeah. for none. And Baron very likely picked up for Rev Respark.
So if you recall the thing I said about 30 seconds ago where they might feel pressure to do something, but all they have to do is do nothing, that's an example of doing something you don't need to do. Mm-hmm. You are under no pressure or obligation to rush a 27-minute Baron on a scaling team code. Before you have scaled. There is, you are down gold, but the game is nowhere near over. The game is much closer to over now that you've lost Baron. I do not, that was a bold call. The desperate times call for desperate measures. Their times were nowhere near desperate enough to call for that measure, in my opinion.
That's true. The pressure was on to make something happen. I don't think it was a crazy idea either. You know, you've got that vein. Like, it is totally possible, but definitely dangerous. I'm more interested in the fact that before that fight broke out, that Victor won a 1v1 against Gangplank. That's pretty impressive. Just, I mean, it's not, no use to look at the gold
Victor
right now.
Victor is sneaky in 1v1s.
Yeah.
Because the shield off of his Q, plus the move speed, makes him in bursty moments hypermobile. And if you're 1v1ing a Gangplank and you can shield and dash around a barrel when he uses barrel combo, you have enough burst to kill him.
Holy shit, to Banana Man, a great flash right there, finding himself in a 1v1 against Aurelion Soul. The question is, can he win this one? That gravity well doing some work right now. Rammus doesn't give a shit about that turret, gonna get in. Braum trying to steal the kill with the Braum ult right there. Very cheeky from Captain Comet. A flash over the wall. Whoa. Hold on, look at that, condemn into the wall. Holy shit, Aurelion Soul taking out 1,000 gold shutdown now. Front to back fight, 4v3 right here. Let's see if Rev can do it. Let's see if Serenity Knights Esports can finally get a win right here in the fight. They absolutely need it. Look at Vayne in the back line getting these autos off. That's absolutely massive. Yep. That's Rammus down. That's Braum down. Going forward, getting pulsed in. Holy shit. That's a 4-for-1. Oh my god. What the fuck?
Since your father is watching and he is proud, you played that very well.
Yes, your dad is in the chat. And
your son is watching but didn't
excited.
Understand what happened because he doesn't play League of Legends.
That's true. Your son plays solitaire, but he's still very proud of you. Victory Slash, last player left alive, doing something very cheeky, very
sneaky. He's going to try to maybe explode.
Nothing scarier than that coming around the corner. Oh, but they're in the choke point. They're in the Baron pit. Barrel chain only hits the dragon, only connects on the dragon. If he's got smite up, this is going to be theirs. Massive get for them. Massive get.
Yeah. And they still get the bounty off of that.
And they get the bounty. Holy shit, they got so much gold off that fight.
They're still way down.
But they're still 8K down. I've got three things to say. First of all, Ojai Vega made the point that this is the first seed versus the 16th seed. Holy hot damn. This is a pretty...
Wait, before you say anything else, I would like to make a note that as you said that, I have no idea which is which.
Yeah, absolutely. No, these guys are punching at relatively even levels. Despite the gold difference, I mean, if you're
another
getting
friend.
Kills this far down in gold, if you're winning fights, I mean, what happens if you've got even gold, right? Hey, down, sweet tea. That's my son. Fuck. What were the other things I was gonna say? I'll get to them if I remember them. Oh wait, no. Plugging the watch party in the Discord, in community channel. Praetorian was talking about it. Listen, if you want to talk to people, if you want to listen to the extra commentary, get in that watch party. It's in the community channel, in our Discord. Lots of friendly folks right there where they can discuss this insane trap that was being placed right there. Look at that. Look at that Gangplank barrel. And you know what? Think about it. If you're on the side of Reverie Spark, you got to think, what's going on? We've taken so many towers. We've broken their base. How did we lose that last fight? You know, there's some amount of, not complete doubt, but just, you gotta check yourself before you wreck yourself energy.
Correct.
Of being a little bit more cautious. And who knows if that's something that the Knights can take advantage of. They're questing for the Grail, and they might find it tonight. Dub Banana Man has shown us that miracles can happen.
Nexus.
The Grail is notably underneath the Nexus. Holy shit, okay.
A little cheeky.
Cheeky indeed. This is the last inhib tower that is up for the Knights Templar.
Vayne's got three items.
Vayne does
Victor's
have three
got
items.
Three items.
Absolutely.
Aurelion Soul has four and Gangplank has five.
Listen, 90 seconds on this Baron. No dragon is up. You really can just batten down the hatches and...
That's what I'm saying.
Munch on this farm.
You really... You want to be munching.
You
want to
be munching always.
Yeah. ABM.
Get a big tummy full. Oh, dub banana man. In a little bit of trouble.
See, slippy.
So slippery.
He's got enough feels left over to get out of that.
You know he plays in a banana costume? Just like one of those big Halloween costumes. Look at that triple barrel. Oh, onions. Good job sneaking out of there.
Little cheeky monkey.
Again, 97 onions. A sentient bag of onions. Playing League of Legends. Victory Slash. Gotta be so careful of these barrels. They deal so much damage. And a 10k gold lead. It is miraculous that the Knights Templar are still able to ride out into battle.
If you're Rev, you're doing it.
Alright. Well, that was a bit of a speed check right there.
You're doing everything right now, though. You are pushing up the waves. You are exerting pressure. You are using gangplank barrels to control zones and chunk people out. You are using this pressure to push waves, to take jungle camps, to set yourself up in a position that when Baron spawns in 20 seconds, you have an inside track. You've got wards. You're there faster, or you can set up a trap. You have stifled them in terms of vision, in terms of gold, because you're taking the camps. All they really have right now is three waves. Yes, there is a wave of supers that gives you a little bit more, but not being able to go out and take jungle
camps.
Look at
Victory Slash. Look at Victory Slash again. Three levels up. God damn it. One barrel. Holy shit. It's a good day to be a pirate.
He's got armor and HP, too.
Baron potentially being started by Respark. Oh, shit. Fuck me. Hold on.
They just take it. 1 second. You can't contest that. Right, so they're starting Baron now. Baron's at 10k. No one on SKT is even near
Baron right now. They're burning it so fast. Holy shit.
If you're Rev, you need to take this opportunity to shut. This Baron is going to be your attempt at winning the game. You have to make the call that this is, like, you. This is still the playoffs. You're playing against a good team. You have to respect them. You have to know that they're scaling. You are ahead. You don't know exactly how much, but you know it's a lot. You know your carries are fat as hell, fat with a PH, and you want to end it here. You
Absolutely.
Don't want to drag this game out longer than it has to. You want to be decisive. You want to use.
You
the
still
gold
got a series to
have.
Play. This is a best of three.
Right. You want to end it here. You want to use this Baron to close the game. It looks like they're going to grab this dragon at 14 seconds. A little bit of a conservative play. They want to, I think, stop any opportunity for SKT to sort of, like, quickly sneak a soul, which will help them defend a little bit more. So they're making the call to just grab it really quick before they try to end with the Baron. I hope. Hopefully, they just grab this and instantly go to a lane. I think they probably 4-1 the GP on a side, or they can just A-Ram it. A-Soul on a side, that's fine. They have TP up also.
They've got great options, you know?
Yeah. The one option they don't have right now is to let this game keep going.
That's true.
Vayne is always scary.
That's
they have four
absolutely
items
true. And we've already seen, I mean, no question, Knights Templar can win these games down a bunch of gold. Now, if a single barrel connects with anyone,
you're done.
If
Lulu
fucked.
Gets hit without a shield on her, I
that's
think
it. I mean, look at that. I mean, that was just the Aphelios Q. That was just a little bit of damage spilling over onto Banana Man.
They're playing this really well. This is exactly how they need to close this game.
That's
just,
true. Victory
you don't
Slash.
Need to push up and fight. You just need to buff the minions and pull them from mid to bottom, back and forth. You sort of got to yo-yo the other team.
100%. Now,
Vayne's a little separated here.
Vayne is a little bit separated. I think they're starting to identify
They know
that.
To pull back, but now
they
they're
do.
Crashing.
Oh, look at that chain. Banana Man's taking so much damage. And they're playing this so patiently, marching this into the Nexus turrets right here.
Three cannons, four
Holding
cannons
off
now.
That choke point, absolutely one turret down.
This is a big enough
Respark,
to end.
Absolutely, they want to, and they know they need to fight Knight Templar going in Vayne, ulting onto the back line as well, going for Pulsen. That's going to be sense flashing backwards as well. A massive knockable. Oh my god, two people down immediately. Three people immediately. Massive shutdowns on the side, and those barrel chains are huge.
Not enough.
I mean, this is going to be an ace in the very end, but a 5-2 right there. Resparked. A brilliant final fight as Resparked take game one in this best of three series versus Serenity Knights Templar. Incredible game.
Yeah, that was huge. Really smart. Really smart closeout from Rev. Rev played everything after that, including that Baron mistake, and they're taking advantage of it. They played it exactly as they needed to. They They found them getting the Baron. They won the fight. They took the Baron themselves. They pushed waves. They had GP in side waves. They had Aurelion Sol in side waves. They were able to take neutrals. They were able to just sort of exert pressure until they got to a point where they knew they could win. Absolutely. You can't always just A-ram it through, but they did all the things they needed to do to win. They sort of just choked him out of the game. 100%. And then they closed it with the other Baron. The game lobby is full of BP dubs.
For sure. Inviting you. You got a spot.
Nice.
Come on down in this clown car. Excellent, excellent, excellent. Link. And you have it. Yeah. So talk to me about variation from game one to game two. Obviously, I think you see the gold generation, the gold lead. You see a lot of cross map plays from Reverie Sparked. They're gonna follow their North Star that led them through game one. What does Serenity Knight's Templar do? What's the variation to game two here?
So this is the really hard decision you have to ask yourself after a loss, because it's a best of three. It's not a best of five. So if you're Serenity Knight's Templar, you lose another game, you're out, right? So you have to make what can be one of the most difficult decisions to make as a team, which is, do we change our strategy or do we do the same one again and do it better and hope that it works well a second time? Mm-hmm. And it is, there is no right answer. You just need everyone to buy in and be confident.
Sure.
No matter what you do. Both of them have an equally good chance of working. If I was their coach going into the locker room, I could go in and I could say, hey, scaling comp didn't work, but you guys played aggressively. You won some fights early. I think we switched to a more early mid-game comp to try to snowball someone and take advantage of that setup. On the other hand, I could be equally right and go in and say, hey, we tried to scale. We made a couple of silly mistakes. Let's draft a scaling comp again and play it a little different to correct those mistakes.
Mm-hmm.
There is no right answer. It is, and anything else is you can't do that kind of Monday morning quarterbacking. You can't have that sort of results-based analysis. You just sort of have to, if everyone buys in and is confident, that's the most important thing. So if I'm Serenity Knights, the main conversation is, guys, we got this. Like, we'll be okay. It's a long series. Let's, you know, what do we want to do? Because right. There really isn't a wrong answer other than everyone being on different pages or being tilted.
Absolutely. I just handed out the Schmeckles. Congrats to the winners who have received a massive payout, because it was probably like 30% to like 70%
Who is the rank one team?
Let's find out.
Yeah.
Let's find out. G John 3007 seed one. Okay, so SKT. Well,
wow.
Oh, yeah. SKT is rank one.
Wow.
Revolution coming in. All right, they are
good
about to start draft.
An underdog story.
Dude, for real. I mean, that shifts the narrative in my head so much.
Yeah.
I think has no money.
So, the conversation, if you're SKT debriefing this game, you need to lock in. You need to say, hey, we're the number one seed for a reason. And they need to all... This is where everyone goes comfort, I think, then.
Mm-hmm.
If they're truly the number one seed, if they have truly proved themselves over the season that they are the best team in their division, pick comfort, show why you're the number one seed, and play to your strengths.
Absolutely. And I mean, let's be real. In... Come playoffs time, you know, you get to the playoffs. The real thing is, how do you play in the playoffs?
Yeah.
Legit, you see it all the time, especially in traditional sports. You get into a playoffs tournament, it's knockout elimination. Upper seeds get knocked out all the time. I'm mainly thinking about Wrexham in the National League. Knott's County almost got knocked out today. In fact, but that's European soccer. We're here to talk about
American League of Legends.
Vidya Games. Hot damn. All right, so draft is live. They're going through it right now. Bans coming out. The Aurelion Soul is getting banned by SKT, but aside from that,
I can't remember who that ban is. I can't remember what that ban was last game. I wonder.
I can't remember what that ban was either. But they
do. Another risky first.
Wait,
pick.
Remember because so many ADCs got banned last game.
Jinx was one of the ones. They banned Jinx in their second round of bans.
Yeah, Jinx got through. I'll tell you what.
It's again another risky first pick, right? Like ADC is a risky position to first pick.
I cast a game on Thursday and
potentially
the game that a team lost 2-1, but the game that they won off the back of this really great Jinx play. We saw how strong it was scaling. There's Ashe, another ADC that was banned. Just interesting,
okay.
These teams getting what has been banned out in the past.
That actually makes sense. So I'm going to reverse what I said before. I actually do like the Jinx pick first because it put all the cards on the table for the ADC role instantly. Because last game, Twitch, Jinx, Ashe, and Caitlyn were all banned. And Rev picked Aphelios first. So there were 5 ADCs off the table before Serenity Knights Templar picked theirs. Rev, by picking the Jinx, makes it comfortable for Serenity to pick their ADC while also continuing to limit the pool in the same way.
Mm-hmm.
So it's not that risky because they probably could have assumed that Serenity Knights was going to pick their ADC early anyway in this first round.
Right.
So it makes it a little bit safer.
Right.
Because then they would have the information that they needed.
Absolutely. Is Braum here being locked in as well? They don't want him to get Ashe Braum. I saw in the chat somebody said that Senses Ashe is cracked. So definitely a...
It was banned last game.
Yeah, that's true. Banned. We were talking about figuring out whether or not things are comfort picks or, some team play. And it's clear that Ashe is a comfort pick.
It also seems like Sense is someone who was getting quite a bit of target bans.
That's very true.
To be fair, they were one of the two positions that hadn't picked yet. Going into the last round and banning ADC is maybe a little more valuable than banning top.
Silas! I like the ults that he can take so far.
I mean,
like
even
the Braum
just
and
the Amumu is dangerous.
Yeah.
Even just the Amumu is dangerous.
Yeah, that's great. All right, you've got another form of engage. A lot of CC coming out of the Knights Templar.
Yeah. Yeah, they've got long-range engage, they have short-range engage, they've got sneaky engage, they've got AoE CC if Silas takes a Mumu ult. I'm interested to see where they go from here.
Restart has a lot of CC and engage as well.
Yeah, so I'm really fascinated by what both teams are going to do in the second round of bans, because it makes sense for them to target a specific position. And it looks like Rev is targeting support instead of top, but it looks like Serenity Knights Templar is targeting top instead of mid.
Mm-hmm.
We got a Renata Lulu ban. Who do they want to pair with this
Gangplank was not picked in the first round.
Yes, they did ban it.
That's very interesting.
Fiora is an interesting ban too. So I wonder, Serenity Knights Templar is probably...
last game as well.
Yeah. Serenity Knights Templar is probably going to pick their support here. I would be surprised if they pick top. They probably want to counter pick for top. Because they already see the enemy support. I wonder who it's going to be, though. It is going to be Rel.
Ooh,
adding another layer
CC.
Of engage.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I like that.
I
feel like they need a little more damage.
Yeah.
Maybe I'm wrong, but...
No, I think it all depends on... It depends on who Rev Respark picks top. Because Serenity Knights Templar is going to get a counter pick on top, and I wonder if they have some ideas about who it's going to be. Pantheon! I have not seen a Pantheon in some time.
Interesting. We got a question, what rank this is. Yeah, Lest Force has got it. Roughly gold with plats and silvers mixed in. Oh, Vega's saying Malphite's even better now.
Yeah, that Pantheon might be mid, by the way.
We have a scoring. Ooh, Trad Boom has urgent news.
Pantheon is mid.
Yeah, we have a point system. Oh fuck, I'm gonna sneeze.
Don't do it.
I'm gonna. I won't do it on stream.
Reader,
okay, I'm fine.
You do it.
I'm fine. We're fine. We have a scoring system. The Gwen here. We have a scoring system at the beginning of the season. We give point values. Renekton! Interesting, being hovered and locked in. Holy shit. All right. All right. All right.
So now Rev has... These are...
Renekton's make me nervous.
Both of these teams make me nervous. Pantheons make me just as nervous as Renekton's do. All
right, game two. I'm going to put these predictions out right now. Who will win game two? You got 10 minutes. Listen, folks, maybe you're going to double down. Maybe you're going to switch the person you're betting on. Maybe the last game convinced you of something. Maybe it was just a fluke. Consider it all.
And when you're done
away your fantasy money,
bet all of your schmeckles on whatever you have decided. Because here's the thing. Let me finish.
Okay.
If you don't, you are fundamentally a coward.
Jesus Christ.
And weak-willed.
You're bringing, like, philosophy into this.
How many do I have? Guess how many I have.
100.
I have 1,100 because I forgot to bet last game. So why don't you
That is shocking. That is shocking.
And now I have 0.
Beautiful. A classic Bigfoot all in. Real quick, let's do some shout outs. Thank you so much to Bobby Frapple. Don't shoot my lout.
Oh, what a name.
And hello, I am Jam. Thank you all for being the newest investors in the low budget LCS. We will see you at the board meetings in Vermont at the Denny's. You got to go around back, talk to our buddy Todd. He's the assistant manager. He'll let you in, but pancakes are on us. Thank
all right,
you guys so much
clarify.
For the follows.
What? Were you saying, hello, I am Jam? Or were you saying his whole name is Hello, I am Jam?
Yes. But the cadence?
Help. Which one is it?
The cadence that I used, I said, hello. And I took a little breath. I am Jam. That's how I imagine it was meant to be said. Jam, let us know.
Sometimes you take a breath to make sure you're pronounced.
That's true. That's true. That is something I do. Sammy Two Slap. It's time for my surgery. I look forward to it. I thought I had booked it for the morning, but
surgery. What?
What? I just get. Sammy just likes to recreationally perform surgery. So.
Oh, that's so sick.
I let him practice.
If you could have any surgery, what would it be?
Any? Just big. Is it functional?
Doesn't matter.
Big wings. Big working wings that fold into my body. So I can still sit in chairs and wear suits.
Okay.
But then I'd also get a suit that was a bit breakaway suit, so I'd be at a at a wedding.
I like that your mind went to suits, a thing that you never wear.
I just RSVP'd.
Like, it would make sense if you were someone who wore a suit for work every day, and you're like, yeah, I still need to be able to wear a suit. It's like, you wear a suit once every 2 years.
I just
don't know what you're talking about.
I just RSVP'd for Boo's wedding. So I
so that's your suits
suit were on the
for
mind.
The year. That's your suit for the year.
Yeah. I'm gonna next time I see you, I'm fucking wearing a suit when I come over to your place. You're gonna look like an idiot. I'm gonna gaslight the hell out of you.
No, because you're gonna show up and I'm gonna be sitting on my couch in a tuxedo
also gonna be
with a pipe. I'm gonna be like,
oh
sorry.
Fuck you.
Didn't realize we were going to the farm today.
Fuck you, dude. God damn.
I can't afford it.
When we go golfing next weekend, let's both wear suits. Hear me out.
Ruin a suit.
Hear me out. Let's ruin two suits.
Off.
Let's ruin
it's gonna
two
be hot.
Suits.
We're gonna have to cut
golfing.
The sleeves off and we're gonna have to cut the pants and the shorts.
Alright. That's perfect.
Trying to plan my outfit. I was texting Tiny Hands today. I was doing laundry and I had some time left in the dryer, so I walked over to the thrift store to peruse collared shirts to see if I could find a stupid one. I couldn't, but the hunt continues.
Listen, Sammy wants to know if we're golfing in suits. You're down. Great. Listen, we're all going golfing, okay? Next Friday, we're all going golfing together, all right? So be there. I can't remember the name of the golf course or where
it is. Doesn't matter. You'll find it. If you were meant to be there, you'll find it.
Look for us. We'll be the two guys in suits.
Yeah, birthday suits. birthday. What else are you gonna wear?
That's true. It is his birthday. You got 5 minutes left to bet. Let's check in with the bets. Many thousands of schmeckles on the line tonight. 38,000 for Revolution, Resparked, 44 for Serenity Knights Templar. Serenity Knights Templar, number one seed. Revolution Resparked, one of the eight seed. Because.
Is this going to get thrown on YouTube?
Yeah, this will get thrown on YouTube.
Possibly. Absolutely. Sure, maybe. Definitely, maybe.
It definitely will.
Okay.
This will be put on YouTube.
Probably.
That's my promise. If my name isn't Buggleberry Finn.
It's funny because it's not.
It's not.
How much does it cost to legally change your name? Asking for a friend. Not really this conversation.
I hope that it's expensive. I hope it's not $3 because then.
Actually, I think it's a couple. I remember I was talking to my cousin who, like over a year after she got married, had still not changed her name.
Love it.
Because she was like, yeah. There's a lot of paperwork, and it's like $200, and I just keep putting it off.
I get it. I understand.
I don't think, they don't have a, I'm not going to say their name because they don't have a league name. Did they? They had the game at one point. Tiny Hands' wife.
Oh, yeah, yeah,
I
yeah.
also don't think has legally changed her name yet.
That's awesome. It has also been, they've had a child since the last time there.
Yeah. Yeah.
Barbecue time. Wait, what's Schmeckles.
What's his last name?
That's a good question. We're gonna find out. We're gonna find out on Friday, or we could text him. Wing time, revving up. 8 ounce sweet tea. The SKT chance coming out. We are 45 seconds. No, we're 37 seconds away.
Plus load time. You never factor in load time.
Never factor in load time. Where are the predictions for game two, though?
The screen's gonna go black for a while. What?
They're around. Oh my god, Revolution resparked so much. Holy shit. Bouncing up to 111,000. God damn. Oak Dasani.
That's good, I think. Great. That's good. That's good.
That's massive. That's massive. Oh, damn, I should have
gotten it. I just put on my Schmeckles on whatever number's lower.
Who put all that money onto them? That was like 70,000 all at once.
Might have been less for.
Could have been less force. I could see that.
Seems like the kind of guy to do it.
He does seem like the kind of guy to do it. All right. Beautiful. Let's see if this button works.
We haven't analyzed skins in a while.
Vega, I was with you when you lost all of the money that you had. Oh, I fucking forgot to do a thing. God fucking damn it. All right. I really hope this doesn't crash the stream. God damn it. I had so much time.
You know it will.
Son of a bitch. God damn it.
You know it will.
I feel like I don't swear that much, and then I do a lot.
Sometimes you do. I think it's great. It adds a lot of flavor.
Thanks, man.
Swear words are just seasoning for your talking.
That's what I say all the time. Okay. Bam. Bam. Look at that.
Boom.
Oh, and it's staying up. Okay, hold on. We've got this. Look at this. Hard.
Oh, we got a five stack.
We do have a five stack. It's happening. Can I cast and do this all at the same time? I can. Okay. Shh, everyone be quiet. Hey.
Now you were too loud.
Oh, that's my bad. Vega being very nice and gifting a sub to Abigail Mattel. Mattia. It's not Mattel. It's Mattie. I apologize when I pronounce your name wrong.
My 12-year-old is watching. Please watch the language.
I'll do my best, but I would encourage you to have a strong conversation with your 12-year-old about language, but if it slips out...
Tell your 12-year-old to invite one of his friends because we're at 99 viewers right now, and I want to teach them some fun words.
We bounced above a little bit. We were at like 103, 105.
I didn't see
Sounds like radio stations. Vega is 12. That's true. I do also know that about Vega. Elocution is dropping. Sorry, Cap Traddish. I'll do my best. but I do need to get water. Hey, you cast alone for a second. I'm gonna go get a glass of water. Sorry to do this to you. Bye, I'll be back.
Finally, we're alone. How's everyone doing tonight? Feeling good? Doing well? Having fun? Staying loose? Hanging out? That's nice. So we've got some League of Legends going on here. I see a little bit of trades in the top lane. Rev trying to close out the series with a 2-0. SKT trying to keep
I'm back. Did
alive.
You do a good job? Oh, wait,
wow,
what
in the
happened?
Middle of it, you it did Vega talk now. Over the sentence I was...
It says that Vega is now of. A caster instead of you. Sorry, I don't know why that's wrong.
You say cast this whole thing, and then you don't even put my name on it?
My bad. My bad. What? I did before. It's a glitch. I'll fix it.
Look how nice. Look how nice I had chat going. We were having such a lovely conversation.
I'm sorry. I apologize.
Abigail Matt Yee says finally some alone time.
I'm sorry. I apologize.
I was really
look
getting
at this
into
gank
it.
Right here. 97 onions coming around right here. It is a sentient bag of onions trying to make a gank. But Gabe Recall able to get his
Ooh,
way
nice
out of there. Cobra Strike in with the CC as well. Sense walking up on their fabled Ash. Two Frost related champions
two
going
Frost,
back and forth
furious.
Here. Lots of CC. Two Frost, two Furious. Super good, dude. That's
hey,
what
does that come
out?
Hang on. Let me look it up. I gotta look it up.
We gotta watch it in theaters.
Yeah. Was it it's Fast X. May 19th. Oh my god, that's so soon.
That's so soon. Wait, that's so okay. soon. Oh, maybe that's we can so go soon. The weekend after next. 60.
Yeah.
That I can't say. 60. SX. 17. Sex, sexy. That's what they're trying to get me to say, isn't it? The Polologist. Yeah, we're confident that SE97 onions is a bag of sentient onions. You know,
put it around we a lot.
I do. I use it to give me some.
Yeah.
Oh.
Cover. It gives you cover.
It does give
me cover. Don't try to dress it up with a different word.
I was trying to find a kinder word. Anyways, Renekton and Gwen, this matchup right here. Victor
Oh my god,
he got a turret charge right there. Holy shit. Pickle hater. I think Ghost. Yeah, Ghost was used there.
And Sam, their flash. Now, Renekton has a pretty good amount of lifesteal just in his kit.
Yeah.
So if he plays this well, he could maybe... No, Gwen's got it back. Okay. He can get the wave in a nice spot.
Look at this. Umumu coming around right here. Banana Man trying to get a kill. He's going to dash away, try and get some distance. Use
Ignite
the wave to cover. Absolutely. Nice. Ignite burned as well, but now 97 onions coming in again. Let's see. Da Banana Man being bait.
I don't think he can do this. I don't think
he doesn't.
Yeah,
he
yeah.
backs off.
Smart to pull off.
Rev up. I like the rev cheer. Oh, look at that.
Ooh,
the engage from Cobra Strike. Great right there.
You got to respect it. I think too many people get caught up in trying to think of, like, the right time to flash and whether or not they're going to waste it or save it for something else. I think for the most part, if you think there is... If something in your heart says you're worried, I think you got to do the respect flash sometimes. And I think Jinx flashing there was fine. I think that was a fine play.
Absolutely. A solid decision. Umumu down here in the bot lane looking to make something happen.
Is he gonna flash bandage toss?
Ooh,
they might try to lane
gank.
You gotta get that last one.
What do you think? They see him or not? Look at this. 97 onions.
Wait, this is gonna get crazy.
Oh,
nobody,
this bag of onions.
Neither team knows the other jungler is here, I think.
I think you're right. It's going to be a surprise. Which surprise will go first? 97 Onions makes the engage with Cobra Strike as well. They're going for the Jinx, but Umumu waiting all the time, but they don't even lose their man. They're going to keep pushing, trying to get that Jinx, but nice Braum Shield up there, blocking a lot of the damage, and now the counterpunch. Oh, the First Blood and Pantheon coming down as well. First Blood taken by that Umumu. Excellent play.
Yeah, nice. Nicely done. We're going to see Renekton is 6. Gwen is not. He's going to try to trade here. Is gonna lose the trade. All right.
I love that Ash gives vision as well. Silas. Yep. Oh, look at the flash forward there. Or, sorry, the engage onto Pulston, the exhaust as well, trying to walk past that Braum shield. That's the Ash going down. Sense gets the kill as well up in the top lane. Pickle hitter ulting too. He's got the ult. He's trying to make use of this level differential right here. One more auto, one W. Look at that. Amumu getting onto the Ash right there. Another bandage toss, another kill. But now, Dub Banana Man. Now 97 Onions. The backup has arrived. More CC from the rel as well. 97 Onions going in. A kill onto the Amumu. That is. Oh, and Gwen died off screen as well. Holy shit. Violence abound. SKT find themselves up in gold.
And the dragon did not go down. SKT gets to take the dragon now, too.
They absolutely do. This is a big win for
them. A little bit. Ash is going to walk in. They're baiting in this choke on this try here. I don't think there's anything they can do. I think that, they just take the dragon. Okay.
I mean, Jinx can always toss something over.
Gwen was solo killed by Renekton at the top. Renekton did a really good job. He actually held his ult for a while. It almost baited Gwen into thinking that she could win that fight, and then he popped his ult and turned it. Gwen had to run away, but he still had flash up, and she did not have ghost. And Tails ult this time. Small girl with scissors killed by large crocodile person.
Are there even original stories anymore?
Just reboot after reboot.
Reboot after reboot. Well, let's take a peek at gold, something I was reminded to do last game, so I'm not going to forget this game. Going down the line, I mean, it is relatively even. Hats off to Rev, who, honestly, just through a lot of farm, are able to even out the gold differential pretty well.
Yeah.
God, these guys love Rift Herald.
Rift Herald is great this early because it's gold on plates. Even if you don't kill the turret, although ideally you are killing the turret, it allows you and a laner of your choosing to get a nice little cash infusion.
Yes.
You got to use it smart.
You do have to use it smart.
Seems like things have settled down a bit.
Things have settled down. There was a lot of motion in the ocean.
Fighting.
That's true. They can hear you, and they will.
I'd be so upset if everything just exploded
everything
right now.
So crazy. For real, though, there was a 200 gold lead for SKT, and Rev has extremely quickly reduced that.
Yeah.
Look at this. Onions coming around right here on a Pantheon. Gabe Recall in a little bit of trouble trying to back up towards the tower, but the second activation of the Wukong ult. Amumu not able to hit that bandage toss. Great CC from Pantheon with the ignite. Yeah. Oh, Rocket goes wide.
Oh, they're not done.
They aren't done. They're going to push the issue right here. Amumu ult taken. Ash arrow doesn't land, but it was super close, but Amumu ult sure does. Look at that. SKT showing
the
they've got chops.
Man has turned the banana peels inside out and has no longer become slippery.
No.
He is now sticky.
Yes. I like that. I like that a lot. Blastco not used there by Cobra Strike? Oh, giving it to Onions. This makes a lot of sense because they want to gank. They are going to walk onto a ward.
This is a risky
Pulston
dive.
Caps comic. Comet. Know what's up. This is a risky dive. They know that it's coming, too. And, I mean, to dive a Braum, of all people.
Right.
He's a frozen
without
ult. Yes.
Although Rels is about to get up.
Banana
they
is the one who knocks now. That was pretty good. That was pretty good. SKT, of course, need to win this game. If they want to keep playing, look at Cobra Strike. Look at this. Look at this at Mumu. He's like, this worked last time. We are going to run it back.
Yeah. I'd like to see Ash play a little more aggressive. They have good range in this matchup.
Well,
right now. And Braum is amazing. Not,
they're being rewarded
for that. I mean, if they play aggressive, now it would not work very well. But in general.
Oh, look at that going right in. Do they have ult? They absolutely do. Both targets hit right there. Sense able to get some distance, but the second bandage toss brings Amumu right to the Ash. And Cobra Strike still able to get. Oh, the shield. Look at Sense weaving, dip ducking and dodging. Guy knows what's up. All right, the Banana Man is on the way. And quite frankly, with the slows, that's going to be the ult. That's going to be the cleanse used right there. But the Banana Man taking the Braum ult.
How many banana peels does this team have?
Dude, so many. So many banana peels. Pantheon coming in, looking for Cobra Strike, but nice. Sense knows he's got to walk up and away. The banana man able to slip out once again. God, this team just disappears into the mist when they need to. Oh, but good Rift Herald.
I do like the Herald. I do like the Herald. Pantheon should stay with it, though. Might have to go mid. They can't. I don't.
8 ounce sweet tea. The kiting. That's my boy. God, what a proud father. Pickle Hater up here in the top lane, fighting it out with Victory Slash.
Pickle Hater's got to be careful now. Victory Slash's ult has those armor boots.
Yes.
Couldn't remember the name. I was going to say Ninja Tabi, and I know they're not called Ninja Tabi, but I only call them Ninja Tabi. I played a Steel Cap. Stupid. Ninja Tabi. Gwen has Ninja Tabi, and... Renekton's got to be careful.
Oh, hey, what's up, Angry Cactus? That's an Angry Cactus, folks. Banana Man in a duel right here onto Gabe Recall, but he does miss some damage right there. Able to dive in, but that's going to be a Jinx Rocket. That's going to be a snipe fucking split right between the uprights right there. A beautiful Jinx ult from downtown.
I've seen Rev play two games, and all I know about them is that their side laners love stealing kills.
Yes, absolutely. It's either Gangplank ults or it's Jinx Rockets, but someone who is not really involved in the fight will get the kill eventually.
They're obsessed with it.
They really
are. That's all they think about.
They love it. Hashtag rev up, Jackie boy. Beautiful. I love the hashtags. Don't forget to tag them on.
I'm surprised
Instagram.
More teams haven't tried to set up some cheap merch. I think Cloud9 has some.
Look at this, Braum all being dropped right there. Sense kind of stuck between a rock and a hard place, but a great flash. That's going to be the Ash Arrow dropped as well. They're able to fight front to back. Amumu going in right there. That's going to be 97 Onions, almost dying to the Rockets. Polston upset about that, wanted to get excited, trying to kite, trying to backwards. That's going to be a zap right there. It does connect, but it doesn't get a kill. Amumu goes down, now Pantheon's here. Can he steal it? So close! Holy shit, 97 Onions doesn't stop the back, just gets over the wall. Ooh, yeah, if you're going to get over the wall, just keep on going, friend. Gets to a try, Bush. They've got full vision of these guys. Dude, Sense really does have a good Ash. Their dad was not wrong.
Yeah.
Their dad was
the movement
not
in general,
wrong.
I mean, I don't think that's unique to Ash. They played a couple of those fights really well with their movement. Especially that last fight where they got that return kill.
Kudos to Rescue, who says 97 onion peels. Beautiful. There are more than banana peels. You're damn right. And those are slippery too. Hot.
Right, you trying to tell me onion peels are slippery?
Next,
they'll line up a bunch of onion peels.
I'm gonna slip you with onion peels when we play golf.
They'll line up a bunch of onion peels.
In our full suits. Here it is, the banana man. Showing us he's still got the moves. Great flash to safety. Dragon is up. Jinx and Braum rotating.
Look at how many wards Rev has.
Yeah, it's a lot. They have
Dragon
lit up.
Lit up.
Nice. Nice hawk shot. Great.
Both teams just sort of standing around.
They are.
Recall might be in danger.
Might be in big trouble. Great juke right there. Is able to find his way out. A little
USA.
Bit of CC. A little bit of flashing. Some summoner spells used.
Population. Gabe Recall.
Well, I mean, last game Rev Resparked pulled so many hijinks. There were so many traps. It was insane.
And now they have a real Jinx with real traps.
Yes, they do. Absolutely. And Rockets to boot. Picklater taking a turret shot there. All right. No contest on the dragon. Direct to camera just didn't even give a shit about that dragon.
Yeah.
Now, two dragons to none.
Yeah.
That's some gold as well.
Yeah, it's gonna be a Cloud Soul.
It is. Caps Comet. Taking some damage.
Wukong's turn to try to lane gank here. I don't know if they were spotted. Rel might try to flash ult.
Ash Arrow connects right there. That's going to be the flash. That's going to be the CC coming in right onto Braum. They're just going to take out the target that they connect with, and they absolutely do it.
Yeah, well, there it is.
Good patient pick.
Yeah.
Ooh,
what
Victory Slash taking a lot of damage. Pickle Hater. Oh, but Pantheon's coming up. They're not going to let Victory Slash go down like that. Pickle Hater stuck between the tower and a very angry Greek guy with a spear and a shield.
Yeah, This is Pantheon mid is really quite excellent just because you can ult to side lanes, and he's done it a couple of times, and I think all but one has been really, really successful. So picks working out so well, 2-1, getting kills in the side lanes.
And here's the real thing. Roaming champions only work if you roam, and this guy certainly has been.
Yeah, that sounds silly. It's 100. It's like astute.
Yes. Yes.
All you see people pick champions that have particular strengths, and you're like, damn, they picked this champion. It's really good at X and Y. And if they play an entire game without ever doing X and Y, then it's a terrible pick.
Right.
So someone might see that Pantheon is like an S tier mid laner and pick Pantheon and be like, why am I not winning the game? It's like, well, they're S tier for a reason. You got to do these things. If you don't do these things, they're not going to be good. So he is playing quite well to the intended, you know, win condition of that pick.
100%. Trad Boom, please let us know what kind of pasta you're eating and if we're timing out Luffy because of his mayo on ramen thing. I'm in full support of it. Yep. Pickle Hater. Okay, got ourselves a little bit of a top lane bash. This is not your, you know, these are the exciting top lane fights with lots of damage and some pretty flashy stuff going on as well. Not a wet noodle contest up here. ZT Kramer, thank you so much for being the newest investor in the low budget LCS. We appreciate the hell out of that follow. We can't wait to see you at the board meetings.
Thanks, man. Welcome.
Now, things have settled ever so slightly in the moment. Of course, we've probably caster cursed it to the opposite right here. Oh, did I not turn on the timers? Dream. I didn't have objective timers on. My bad to the folks at home. 2 minutes till this next dragon. Look at the positioning of 97 onions. All 97 onions in one spot, ready to strike, ready to pounce. Onions, the most violent vegetable. You gotta be careful when you're playing
second,
with onions.
Of course, the second most violent vegetable being.
Yes?
Who is that again? Well, who is the second most violent vegetable?
The most second violent vegetables are pickles. That's why he hates him so much.
Are they vegetables?
Lost his whole family in a pickle fight. It's pretty fucked up. We don't like to talk about it, but you did indeed dive back into this horrible trauma. But we
are my favorite food.
We do what
we
can. Sense is in some trouble here. Dude, I'm with you, dude. Pickles fucking
rock. I don't care what pickles have done to this guy's family. They've done nothing but good things for me.
Now, I know... Oh, dodges the zap, gets hit with the Braum Q, the name of which I don't know. Any Braum heads out there who want to tell me what that... thing
yeah, any Braum heads out there?
Any Braum heads out there? Gator is a good vegetable, like alligator. Sammy, for a doctor, I don't think you know what vegetables are. Gators are green. Are all green things?
Smart.
Vegetables?
Yep. Tonight I had some chicken, I had some rice, I had some green crayons.
Absolutely, really 97 nice. Onions coming around right here. That's going to be damage. Toss coming in. Da Banana Man taking a Mumu ult. That's one of Mumu ults used. Will the next one be used? Absolutely. Flashes into the Jinx ult, but it's still not enough to kill him. That's a slippery banana. But his friend does go down. The onions.
Banana is so
not quite as slippery.
Guess what healthy snack I'm eating right now?
Is it
not a green crayon.
Is it raw onions? Is it gator?
Yep.
Is it gators?
Yeah.
Okay, alright.
It was a mandarin.
Ooh, mandarins are delicious.
Yeah.
Excellent. Excellent. Dicky. This dragon coming up. Bigfoot, who do you think's got the edge coming into this dragon fight?
Well, both two really impactful ults were just used. Being the Amumu ult and the Silas ult. So it is going to be a bit of a short-handed fight in terms of ultimates. I think it's probably...
Okay,
yeah,
Victory Slash going in. Pickle Hater trying to go for a turn right here. Holy shit, this is close, but Gwen has it. And they get the dragon. These are big moves for Rev.
Yeah. I mean, neither team can really fight there.
Pantheon comes screaming into the mid lane, right onto the Banana Man. Let's see if he can get out. Takes a turret shot. I thought he was out of turret range, but apparently not. And the rest of Rev on the way. A Jinx Rocket comes rushing by right here. Can he make it over the wall? Is not able to.
And
that's a lot of Rev people.
SKT taking this turret. Ooh!
Oh, Ash Arrow. That's a beautiful Ash Arrow.
I was just going to say, A, that Ash Skin Arrow is gorgeous. Yeah, B, when you're dodging an Ash Arrow, attempt to not flash in a straight line, which Jinx almost did. That was very scary for a hot second, but they just avoided it.
Absolutely. All right, Pantheon. Taking on this tower. Does get the tower kill. 97 onions. Getting the knockup right there. Ooh, let's see. The 1v1 right here. Might be going Pantheon's direction. Let's see. But Renekton is on the way. A flash. Ooh, to get the extra slice and dice. Really well thought out. Oh, but Braum ult and an exhaust as well. Stopping Renekton in their tracks.
Well, because this time Pantheon is a melee champion. So as he's been fighting with Banana Man, he actually is in range to take some of the peels. So he's been slowly this game covering himself in banana peels and therefore was able to escape that fight.
Absolutely. Jinx Rocket's going down. Yep, dub Banana Man in a little bit of trouble, but he is going to dive in, maybe try to get an assassination onto the Jinx right there. Even for being locked up for a long time, he was able to get a considerable amount of damage down. Victory Slash going for a kill, going to start this fight. That's a W over the wall from Sense. This is Ash, the 2v1 right there. Can they get the kill? Gwen is immune, but not to Ash. Sense getting that kill in the very end right there.
Was that a no, it wasn't a shutdown. Okay, I thought that might have been a shutdown. So, this is a very tight game.
Another friend.
Jinx has two items now.
Yes.
And is starting to scale.
Yes.
Ash has 4 kills.
Tell me more.
Sylas is always going to be useful with his ult. The scariest thing, if I am Serenity right now, is that Renekton, he already kind of falls off and is behind.
Mm-hmm.
So they need to be really careful about side lanes in particular, because wherever Gwen goes, they don't really have someone to answer the Gwen. I don't know if Sylas can do it, and Renekton really is not going to be able to without help.
Right.
So Gwen really is going to have a free lane if it ends up being a true 1v1.
Absolutely. Will English... Oh, never mind. Sorry.
Will English what? Will English what?
Will English has followed us.
Oh.
Let me see if I can get my Roman numerals right. Is that 6?
Let me see. Is it VI? VI is 6.
It's IV. It's 4. It's 4. All right. Well, we were close. Don't worry, team.
Again, this we.
Sorry.
Really?
My producer's in my ear. Oh, look at that flash. Look at 97 onions. They found their target. Excellent. Excellent execution.
They're pinging Baron.
Goddamn,
Sense. They might just go for the vision, but they might be emboldened.
They might, and that I wouldn't argue with them. I don't think that's a bad idea. It looks like A down Sweet T has also followed us. The father of Sense right here. Ash Arrow does go wide. Oh, Banana Man doesn't connect.
If either of those hit, they get a kill.
Absolutely.
Banana Man has... Okay, so Banana Man... didn't miss an ult, he just misses E. So that's going to be off cooldown soon, and he's got a Moomoo ult. They can just do this and have Banana Man threaten exactly what he's doing right now. He needs to be
Absolutely.
Sitting in the opening and threatening this play. The second he sees an opening, he needs to go for it.
Gabe recalls here as well. They've got the 4v5. This is as strong as Rev is going
to
get for at least a couple more seconds. Pickle Hitter peels off at half health right here. Does he have ult? He does. He pops it, but a massive Amumu ult. That's going to lock down, and a Jinx Rocket still gets in, still able to participate, but it does look like SKT able to fight through it, able to get these kills. That's 3 kills for none for SKT,
really,
and they pull back onto the Baron.
So smart. Baron was still had about a third
Holy
of their health
shit.
They could have kept chasing, but instead they turn back. They're going to take the Baron. They win the fight. This is huge. Sense picks up another kill. Sylas played that really well.
Oh.
I thought it could have gone either way for a hot second, but SKT gets 3 kills, 4-0, gets the Baron. They are now up 1,500 gold. They need to push this. They need to use this advantage to push out waves. They need to position around this dragon. They have Ash and Sylas ult almost already up. Wukong ult is still up. They have so much advantage right now. Gwen does have TP, but is it going to be up for another 10 seconds? Amumu just spawned right now. They can use this time to set up around the dragon. They want to get this third dragon. Yes, it's Cloud Soul, but this is a really good opportunity for them to just sort of grab a bunch of stuff for free and push the issue. They want to start baiting out fights. This Ash is going to keep winning fights for a while. They need to take them and keep snowballing this Ash.
They absolutely do. Sense is absolutely cracked. Eight ounce Sweet Tea was true to what they said about their son. Their Ash is on fire here. Jinx Rocket does go. God fucking damn it, this fucking spectator. I swear to God, this spectator climb. Son of a hostage. All right. Well, who got that? Was it a steal?
Dave got it, I think. It was a steal.
Fuck this fucking spectator client. I swear to God.
It was Jinx.
This is insane. That absolutely ridiculous. Wait, Ruffian, is the stream down or did it just do the flicker? God damn it.
Stream's up.
Alright, son of a bitch. Zodiac, don't turn the lights off like that, man. Boy, I bet that was pretty cool. I bet that was pretty fucking sick. Oh, yes, all that water I was drinking.
Yeah, that big mug of water.
It is a container for mug water.
Okay, yeah, this is not how anyone says they have. No one has a mug of water. They have a glass of water. I'm having some water. Who's going to sell a
all
mug
right.
of water?
Well, regardless. Sorry that we missed that great. It would have been sweet to clip that, huh?
Use your imagination.
Bet these teams would have liked to have that recorded. Don't worry, though. This will be on YouTube. Also.
Yeah, with the flicker.
No, dude, it's different. It's different.
I don't think it is.
No, man, it's definitely different. PC Jackie Boy, thank you so much for the Prime resub, 15 months. Hashtag RevUp and Luffy, tier one sub, 5 months, says hi, Vega. Love it when people talk to each other in chat and use subbing or following as a way to do that. Vega, it says you're casting because the thing messed up and it's the stream and now I don't want to tab over because we're watching the game. Vega, you are Bigfoot. Bigfoot is you.
We are all you.
That's true. Look at this engage right in here. Hold on. Fighting at a choke point. Breaking out right now. Jinx Rocket does connect. That's going to be one of the Moomoo's going down. Moomoo going quite low. Ash finding herself in the back line. Ash Arrow getting launched out as well. Finding a target. Pantheon going down. This is
Ash
going quite well for SKT. Moomoo gets taken down as well. Sense in the 1v1 against Pulston. Did I say 1v1? Sorry. Because all of SKT is still up. A massive win there for the Knights Templar as they continue their quest for the Grail.
They're gonna get it. This is looking like their game.
This might be the game. We've got, what, 26 seconds on the death timers, a Baron-empowered wave, and a rampaging group of knights breaking down the top side of the map, cutting through. Yeah, they've got it. I think they've got the minions right here. First inhib turret, what are we at, 10 seconds left? And just for Braum to come back up? Next turret, holy shit! And we have got ourselves a series, folks. We will be going to game three. As SKT takes game two over Rev Resparked.
Okay.
I fumbled those words. My vocabulary is not good today. Anyways, fucking sick. Holy shit. God.
What a statement. Closeout. Both teams now. The series is evened up. It's now just a best of one.
It is now just a best of one. These guys absolutely cruising.
Cruising the world.
Beautiful. Now, will they stay on the same sides? They've saved me a lot of work. Uh-oh. Oh, no. Okay. There's something about going out of Twitch chat, or going out of the game and then turning the music back on that makes my whole fucking thing freak out. Bigfoot, we're going into game three. Talk to me again about adjustments. They're 1-1. They've learned a lot from each other. But what are the final takeaways that both teams need to make to bring themselves a win?
Well, sorry, there's not something over Spectre. Look, the calculation is completely different now because it is the highest pressure situation both teams are. I'm so sorry, I knocked over something. This is high pressure for both teams now, right? Both teams are on the brink of being eliminated. The team that most recently won has the momentum, right? Mm-hmm. They are coming off of a win. They know they can do it. I knocked over the piano. They know they can do it. And They are feeling energized. Rev might feel a little back against the wall. I think at this point, I don't know.
It's tricky. Gold, for the most part, was still going quite strongly in the favor of Rev for, vast majority of that.
It's the same thing I was thinking and saying before, right? Like, I don't know.
Bigfoot, you got to drop down in the spectator.
Okay, that's what I was going to say. It's the same thing I was saying where it's like anything could work, right? There's not really a right answer. You could say, hey, let's mix it up. Let's do something unexpected. That could throw a team off and work. You could say, hey, let's play it safe and do what, won us game one. I think both teams at this point, it seems pretty clear to me that Sense is someone and the Banana Man are people who need to be on the radar. Victory Slash also, right? Like, you need to kind of see, because when you go into a series, you've done some scouting. But a lot of that scouting can sometimes get thrown out the window once you start actually playing the series, right? Mm-hmm. That's how, like, sort of, like, mini metas start to develop inside of a series. And some things you may never have scouted or thought about picking your banning are all of a sudden on the table because of the way the series has gone. So, in the same way, players change from series to series, right? Nobody here is a professional League of Legends player. Even professional League of Legends players are inconsistent sometimes. So now that you've gotten this deep into a series, I think one of the things you have to start asking yourself is who are the, not necessarily the positions, not even necessarily the champions, but who are the players that we need to focus on banning, that we need to focus on adjusting for, trying to prioritize getting them a counterpick, trying to prioritize counterpicking into them. And I think the strategy of game one, limiting the options for Sense to get ADC, is a smart adaptation and adjustment that Rev can go back to. I think making sure that you get top counterpick, a thing that SKT has done a couple of times, needs to keep happening as well, because Victory Slash is sort of popping off here and there. So I think the shifts that these teams have to make, whoever can make the most well-informed shift about what they've learned in the last 2 hours is probably going to win this game. Because both teams have shown that they can play evenly. They are matched well against each other. The series is 1-1 going into the final game. Like, how more even does it get? Neither games were really blowouts. Sense is a wide pool. I believe you. That makes a lot of sense. but in game one, he went down to a sixth available ADC. And when a lot of the generally solid performing ADCs are off the table, you might end up feeling like you need to go in a different direction and pick something that's not as typical, pick something that maybe your team's not as comfortable playing around, pick something that maybe doesn't fit into a comp as well. But we'll see what they do.
We will indeed. Draft is starting. Yeah, into the rubber match, into game three right here. Absolutely incredible. No matter how this ends, both teams have put on an incredible performance. I did just hand out the money to folks. Sammy Two Slap got 27K, Rescued 1-4. Oh, snap. All right, we've got some wealthy bettors. I can't wait to see what the betting pool looks like. So far, predictions have been wrong both times. The team that has been bet on more has been the team that has lost.
Caitlyn, Rash. Is Rev gonna ban Twitch?
Hashtag Night Night. Oh, goddamn.
Rev has banned Twitch every game so far. They have one ban left and they haven't. I wonder what they do here. Silas.
The Silas taking it out of Banana's
hand. So an ADC that has been off the table for two games is now on the table unless Rev is going to first pick it, which I think is probably unlikely, but let's see. Also, as an aside, I'd like to make a note just how awful that new Hecarim icon looks.
It's so bad.
It's just a miss.
I don't think you
and
can
honestly,
find
most icons are super solid. Most League icons look great. Mm-hmm. That one is easily the worst one now.
There is
no other. Also, the new Kassadin one is not as good as the old Kassadin one either, I think.
Yeah, they look
Wukong first pick. Pick away. They take the Wukong.
Interesting.
Wukong's pretty strong enough. They grab it.
Very
I wonder the response. Serenity Knights Templars also chose it very early last round, so this might also be an attempt to sort of throw them off their plans. I wonder if they grab jungle here anyway. They grab the ash again. Okay. Do they pick jungle here? If I'm Serenity Knights Templar, I pick jungle here. I don't know which one I would take. It depends on what their sort of larger plan is, but I think you'd take jungle here.
Yeah, I don't know. I'm going to be real. I was never the draft guy. But another sense ash game. Yeah.
There you go.
People are talking about it in chat. It's fucking
Frosty Gals.
The Frosty Gal Sejuani as well. Just go ice themed. There's actually a lot to be said for just
It is funny because there are a lot of themes you can do, but ice is legitimately good and they synergize with each other.
They absolutely
You can't
do.
Like make an all fire comp that synergizes with
right.
Poison also synergizes with itself.
That's
you
true.
Can stack
get a bunch of
I think poison works well together.
Do
we see the Jinx from Reverie Sparked?
Yeah, what do you think about this? They're running him back. It's a great pick.
It's good.
Tom Kench makes it
a little better. I am a little concerned an Ash being picked a Jinx being picked instantly into Ash Sejuani. I immediately don't think that is a good matchup in either early game.
Interesting. Why is that?
Sejuani ult is a nightmare for Ash. Oh, great. Here's more nightmares for Ash. It also just is a very vulnerable pick, right? There's so many ADCs available. Blitzcrank and Sejuani.
Gotcha.
And then Ash wins lane against Jinx pretty hard. Ash into Tahm Kench Jinx is probably pretty happy. If I'm Sense, I'm pleased with this lane matchup. And then late game, the Tahm Kench helps a little bit, but now there's a lot of targeted CC and kill threat onto the Jinx between Blitzhook, Ash ult, Sejuani ult. Jinx basically has to go cleanse this game.
A Blitzcrank pick is a real vote of
it's
confidence.
Old though. Yeah, it's the Blitzcrank, you know, as annoying as it is for the Ash, it is still a risky pick. It does allow them to have that sort of comeback potential, right? You can always win a game if you have Blitzcrank. And someone's always going to be out of position. It's just a question of if you can see it and you can take advantage of it. So it is valuable, but it is a little, you know, it lacks a lot of the things that other supports can do. It has that incredibly good pick potential, but its peel is medium. It's not particularly tanky. It doesn't offer anything in the way of heal or shields or other sort of supportive stuff.
Real
it really is.
These picks are coming in. The Gangplank and the Fiora still banned. Victor and Lissandra gone now. And a Syndra.
The answer is a Syndra. I haven't seen a Syndra in a hot second.
I actually, there was one
blind.
Played in another playoff game tonight.
I love Syndra in general.
She is great. The question is, what's the response going to be from
really
Sparked?
Right now, but Syndra's one of those champions where if you're good at her, it's pretty safe to pick. They also, once again, grab a top counter pick. Three games in a row, they have prioritized counter pick for top, not mid. There's a cannon!
Huh.
Okay. It's a blind pick. It's not an awful blind pick.
No. I mean,
now what are we going to see?
Interesting.
Here? There's no Aurelion Skull. They could go Pantheon again because they have AP in the top lane.
That's true.
It isn't a Syndra, so you could pick something. Oh, Gragas. Okay. Yeah. You really have two ways to go with Syndra. You can pick another Control Mage, or you can try to do something bursty. Gragas is pretty bursty.
Interesting.
Gragas, I think, is a little anti-synergistic with this team. I don't love it. Gragas ult.
But he can do some surprising things, and he can pop
Yes.
Ideally, he can pop the Ash and the Syndra out of place.
Yes.
Olaf. I like that.
Interesting.
I like
okay.
the Olaf.
Yeah, Olaf's cool. There's not a ton. Yeah, there's not a ton of engage on Rev's team.
Well, if you think that matters or anything else, you can show us by betting with these predictions. Here we go. Predictions live. Who gives a fuck what we say? Vote with your wallet.
I do.
Captain Radish, there are your Schmeckle bets. Also, Pyrosy, you followed us 13 minutes ago. I didn't say a goddamn thing about it. My apologies. Thank you so much. Thank you so much for following. We appreciate that. You know, usually there's like a whole spiel about coming to the board meeting, where it is, how to get there, but I just want to say really quickly, just from me to you, thank you. And I'm sorry that I didn't say something 13 minutes ago. And I know I'll never be able to make it up to you, but I just want to put this apology out there for you. All right, 34K being bet on Serenity Knights Templar fucking immediately. Holy shit. Lots of people saying all in. Oh my god, you guys are following Bigfoot's laws of gambling.
Of gambling, yeah.
Bigfoot's, you know how they have like, you know, Newton's, you know, laws and stuff? Bigfoot has one law.
Yeah.
One law, all and in. That is all in.
All in, baby.
Oh, if it isn't Will English the fourth, not Will English the sixth, nobody would make that mistake.
Only an imbecile.
Would call me an imbecile. Perfect. All right, we're just gonna hover on this screen for a second. Well, they're picking it in client, just so y'all can continue to see all the picks and vote. You know, Ohio's got 3,600 on the underdogs, easy money. Oh my goodness. Hashtag night night. And hashtag rev up. There have been some great cheers tonight for these teams. You guys have been an incredible audience. And we'll have to do it again sometime. Hey, everyone, in 1 year, let's all meet up here. Oh, never mind. We'll enjoy the night while we've got it. Foolish sucker, what do we want to see you do again? Holy shit. Hey, it's Will English the fourth coming in with a sub for 1 month. Will, shucks, man. Thank you so much. We appreciate the hell out of that. Captain Radish, you're too kind. Thank you so much. Luffy all in. Foolish Shuck is berating, pushing somebody to go all in, and Luffy right away. Luffy, who, by the way, messaged me while it wasn't on screen and said, Kragas skin, but the barrel's a bottle of Duke's mayo. So that's horrible. Wild. Wild stuff. All right, let's get over to the client. Y'all can make sure that there are no picks in any crazy positions. Can confirm that nothing's too insane here. Nothing's too insane at all. At all. Will English.
Sorry, my mic was muted.
Would you say anything cool while it was muted?
No, I was just kind of talking about the draft.
All right.
Excitement. General excitement about the game. Not really sure who's going to win, though I did bet all of my schmeckles.
Good.
Doesn't matter.
Ooh.
The important thing is spending all
of them. You don't want to say.
No, just the important thing is spending all of them.
The important thing is spending all of them. Very close. Very close betting pool. We have broken the 100K Schmeckle count.
Wow.
On this particular game three. Miss Mystic Azzy, thank you so much for being the newest investor in the low budget LCS. We will see you at the board meetings in Vermont at the Denny's. You gotta go around back, talk to our buddy Todd. He's the assistant manager. He'll let you in. But pancakes are on us. Thank you so much for the follow. Incredible. Game three of this round one of playoffs in the low budget LCS in the commercial league. Who will win and be able to move on, and who will see the end of their season 10 of the LBLCS and tonight? We will find out together in roughly?
On tonight's edition.
On tonight's edition of
Low Budget LCS.
Low Budget LCS. Yeah, man. I'm thinking of doing a summertime series, just like a once a week night conversational stream, because it'll be our off season. Our next season won't start until September, and it's still coming together in my head, but the name that I have for it is the current working title is Long Walks and Summer Talks, a symposium on culture and other things. And that's the title. It's a very long title.
But, no, I think the important thing is that you have a really, really long title.
Long titles are everything. Long titles are literally everything.
Yeah, because you really want people to be able to... You really want to be able to make it hard for other people to articulate what they're doing.
I don't want someone to casually be able to say that they were watching a show. I want them to have to struggle to get it out. And I love the abbreviation for it, which is also super long. I'm not going to bring it up again. Lil Dear Lilia, unfortunately, we've done summer splits in the past, but we, you know, we give it our all. We put our hearts and soul into the league, so we need a little time to recuperate. We usually our like working schedule now is like, you know, so every season's 2 months of the regular season, and then we do a month for playoffs, or you know, kind of as long as it takes. We want to keep it under a month, but anyways, they're with Luffy. Don't worry, the ARAM tournament is definitely coming this summer as well.
Have we ever finished the other one?
No, we never finished the first ARAM tournament. It stopped in the finals, and every player is still in the LBLCS, and they just haven't done it. So we will also wrap up the first ARAM tournament that was started like 2 years ago. When that happens, 2-1.
Game time!
As long as there are no rampant technical difficulties.
Which has never happened.
Never happened before. Stream's never gone down. Stream has never gone down. Oh, thank God. Beautiful. Kaiji, this is my first time watching either team, so I'm just here to balance out the rivalry. Hell yeah. Hashtag night night. 8 ounce sweet tea, a proud SKT dad. Just a proud father.
It's what you like to see. Here at the Low Budget LCS, we're all about fatherhood.
And we're all about family and going fast and being furious about it.
Being so furious.
We're so mad at how fast we're going.
So mad at how we're going. We're going fucking so fast going because so we're fast. Mad at the never ending cycle of being mad and quick.
And quick. Yes, very agile. Agility. Important in all things, but especially in this game 3. Look at that transition, guys. Revolution resparked. Oh, hold on. Is that a little Tom Kench? Do we get the flash pull? Cobra Strike. Or Koba Strike, as maybe some more afraid people might say. Great invade here. Listen, these are the appropriate responses. They pick a Blitzcrank. You know what's up. You know what's up. You know there's an invade coming. You better get good and ready. It's a great Blitzcrank sting skin, though. You are ready?
Yeah. That sounded like you were farther away from your microphone. I thought you were talking to somebody else. I thought you were talking to somebody else.
No. No, just, are you ready?
Yeah, yeah.
Just a panicked. No.
You ready?
Just...
I'm ready. Let's do it.
Pouring the last of the water out of my Brita filter because I've drank a whole big thing of it before that.
Yum. Yum.
All right. Here we are. Game 3 starting out with Serenity, Templar, Knights Templar. Damn it, the SE messes me up. I'll be real. Pull back the curtain a little bit. The SE, I see it and I was like, oh, it's Serenity Esports, but I want to put the Knights Templar in. Detective Purple on the case. Wukong First Blood, they're calling it. Okay.
We'll see how that plays out. I'm gonna say it's an ash first blood.
Okay. Yeah, sense on ash again. Sense his dad, 8 ounce sweet tea, was telling us how proud he was of his son for being such a good ash player. And you know what? I think we saw that in game two. Sense really played a crucial role in the success of the Knights.
I would argue the most crucial role.
Certainly one of them. What a gentle way to disagree with you, right? Hashtag sense the victory. Lil Dear Lilia in with a monster chant. That's great. Beautiful. Oh, sorry. 8 ounce sweet tea said that first. Okay, now other people are saying it. All right, my bad. I am drinking water, guys. Come on. I would not be able to do this with any alcohol in my system. I have an extremely low tolerance.
Sure is good, baby. I assume it's what and a little baby drinking alcohol would be like.
That's true. Unless we're out there.
I've drank with you and a lot of babies.
That's true. I've pulled back on the vodka Red Bulls. It was really just the month of January. There were just a lot of drinking events that happened, and you happened to be there for almost all of them. Pickle hater. A little bit of early dueling.
I feel like I don't talk enough about how angry I am about pickle hater.
Listen, he knows. He's ready. He knows what he did when he picked that name. He's ready for when he pickled that first name. Wukong getting this scuttle up here. Better casters would be really building tension for you guys, pointing out matchups, telling you, talking about the storylines, the evolution of these players, this whole back and forth top lane matchup, victory slash versus pickle hater, the kinds of champions they've played, why this game three is different than games one and two, and wondering, will victory slash still be as dominant and as scary, or will pickle hater persevere in the lane? I feel like pickle hater has done an excellent job once the map opens up, but it's really just been a matter of like holding victory slash back, first on that gangplank, then again on that Gwend, just back to back banger gangs, and here we go. A gank right here in the mid lane, forced flash. There was a gank and I was trying to say game. It came out half and half. We got there.
You got it, man.
Thanks, dude. I appreciate that. No blitz pulls yet. The most dangerous hook, the one that's never thrown. The one that is yet to be thrown.
True. We see Blitzcrank and we talk a lot about, oh, the hook's really dangerous, but when you're laning, you don't really want to throw it. The threat of a hook is incredibly valuable.
Look how far back they're playing right now, just knowing that at any second a fist could come screaming out of that bush.
And the second he uses it, they can play way up.
Way up.
Way up in there.
With that TK up there ready to gobble up Polston. I mean, can't do that yet, but he will. He will. Look at that sense walking up too. Look at this bot lane from the Knights Templar really, really playing with each other. They understand each other's presence. Oh, but maybe, just maybe, Rev was buying time. Now they know to start the fight. Traps thrown out. That's an invisible Wukong, but they know, they sense it. Tahm Kench still going in. Look at that. Dip, ducking, and Daijin. Daivin, sense, able to find themselves to safety. A force flash from the Tahm Kench. We're seeing the Fjordians working together right here. That's a lot of CC, a lot of slows coming down, and first blood goes to sense, but it's not over yet. A massive pull from Koba.
Sometimes those hooks are mostly psychological. Nice. I'm so sorry. We really should have been talking more about the game and doing analysis, except I did say one thing, which is that the first kill was going to ask, so look what happened.
You fucking did. You called it. Detective Purple, I'm sorry. I'm sorry, man. I know you wanted it to be true.
Yeah, well, but the counter gank was the key. They don't pay you the big bucks.
That's why we don't pay you the big bucks, and instead we pay Bigfoot.
Me, no bucks.
The big bucks. We pay you both the same. For what it's worth, your salary is exactly equivalent to Bigfoot's salary.
Hang on, I have an email. So
all right, totally fair. Captain Radish, 8 ounce sweet tea, sense the victory. Absolutely. What is this? Is this subterfuge? Deception afoot?
Subterfuge?
Subterfuge? Banana Man just in here. Throwing lots of circles in the mid lane. Got barrels, we've got orbs. Cobra Strike with the pull. Can't imagine they're going to kill Tom Kench on this, but they're going to hurt him.
You're going to drive.
You're going to shoot him with a bunch of arrows, and just look at the farm diff down here in the bot lane. In favor of Sense right here by a pretty good margin. All right. Pickle hitter. Getting one auto attack off on pickles. on that ward.
Continues to hate pickles and be on the wrong side of history.
That might be the case, but we'll see. Ooh. God, I kind of forgot about...
Yeah, Syndra can be really annoying.
Exactly. Yeah, just that whole thing that Syndra does.
Yeah, that thing where she pokes you from far away and then sends you and then chunks you a bunch.
Yeah, deals a bunch of damage. Gabe Recall also playing a pretty different kind of champion for this match. There's been a lot of champion variety in this series.
Interested to see what the Gragas does later. Oh, hey!
Or right now, look at that. Oh. A great play into the turret shot. Absolutely takes it. Dub Banana Man with a nice pushback. Holy shit! How could we forget how slippery those banana peels are?
So
you just can't go. Oh! That is what we call a fadeaway three-pointer, folks. Oh. Holy shit. Dude, just don't gank him. I feel like he's earned a rep already. Sejuani ult being used, a great pull from Koba. I don't even think he expected that to hit because Sense was nowhere near him.
Yeah, you should really be making gagging Pickle Hater a lot more, mostly because of his views about pickles, but also because it was what was working the last couple of games.
God damn. What a slippery fella. But also, can we just call out how fucking clean is Gabe Recall on this Gragas? That was like a perfect combo.
Yeah, that was what I was thinking about and saying right before it happened, which is Gragas actually does so much burst damage if you line up all your things correctly. It's very difficult to line up everything correctly, but like setting up a barrel, ulting them into the barrel, stunning them, blowing it up, that's later on when you have more AP.
Ash arrow right away, there's the cleanse, there's the ult, but Koba is gonna pull Kench back, a classic Die Fear support situation, and the silence as well, so clean from Koba, and this is the whole Ash thing. You cannot outrun an Ash, but, oh, Wukong, maybe he waited too long? No.
Yeah, he had to wait. He's there just to cover. He went in right when it was too late. They were never going to be able to turn it. They just wanted to make sure that Jinx lived, and she did. So, not the end of the world, but another kill over to Ashe is not what you want.
No, certainly not. Sense has proven how dangerous they are on this champion.
Wait here. Maybe two. Probably just the one.
Oh.
Yeah. Sejuani coming up to gank top. Walked over a ward, knows it, goes to clear it.
Absolutely.
Cannon is six. Everyone's got ults.
Yeah, we're starting to come online here for...
Sejuani Ashe is such a brutal combination of ults.
Say again?
Sejuani Ashe is such a brutal combination of ults.
Yes. It absolutely is. And then just anything else you throw into the mix is gravy on top of everything. Yeah, Vega, interesting comment. I don't think we know anything in this game till the first objective fight where Kennen and Wu can be good. That's true. Choke points?
Speaking of, Ashe is pinging Dragon.
Ooh.
Less than a minute.
Less than a minute, 40 seconds till that Dragon's up. I wouldn't trust the objective timer telling us it's a Cloud Drake. That is one of the many fun... Is it a bug or a feature? It's hard to tell.
It's a bug.
Where it just always says it's Cloud. Or it often does. Koba is hitting these pulls.
Yeah. Yeah. And they've got some kills because of it. It's also psychological, right? Like, it is not a fun ability to play against, and it does not feel good to get hit by it.
Right.
And if it happens a bunch, even if they're not leading the kills, it is something that's kind of on your mind. And it makes you really have to respect it in fights.
Absolutely.
And any amount of brain power that you have to dedicate to thinking about that is, you know, one less brain cell that you're going to be covering other stuff. It's a very disruptive.
You're trying to make
champion.
People flinch.
Oh,
like, look at this. Oh my God. Comet forced to flash before the dragon. Jinx Rocket does connect with the Blitzcrank, but not a problem. Not a problem at this point in time. I think
a 15 second cooldown for a 5 minute cooldown.
Yes. very, very happy with that trade. Pulling the dragon out, starting it up right here. Olaf staying in the top lane. He doesn't have teleport, and Kennen is on their way down. They're grouping up. They want this to be the team fight. Onions playing as the frontline card as well. A massive, oh my god, massive scatter of the week, but a huge ult from the Gragas right there. Absolutely massive, isolating Banana Man, who's still trying to find his way to the back line right there. Lives for a long time. But look at this, a 1v1 Pulston versus Sense back here. Now, Tahm Kench coming down. A great flash from Sense through the exhaust, though he's unable to get the kill. Tahm Kench eats him up, and a very, very clean collapse from Rev. Holy shit!
Rev played that great. Honestly, the Wukong clone was perfectly placed. It ate an Ash Arrow, and then instantly after they all walked up thinking that they were safe, Kennen came out and ulted three of them. And I thought that was such a good start because Banana Man had a great Syndra stun on three of them, but there just wasn't enough damage to pop them yet. And...
oh, and I mean, it's Hexgate map.
Yeah, kills are picked up by both solo laners again for Rev. This Kennen has been quietly dominating the top lane in terms of farm as well. I mean, the same farm lead has existed on the other team in the other two lanes, but Kennen is, I mean, this is what I was saying earlier, right? Like, you have to start playing around players, and if some players are having a good series, you really got to play around them, and Victory Slash has had a great three games.
Absolutely. Oh my god, look at this, Olaf flashing forward. He gets another slow right there. Onion's there as well, but that's a lot of damage that Kennen
put
out.
Boy, did I jinx that.
Jinx Rocket? I thought that you were saying that because Jinx was throwing a rocket.
No, I was saying that because I just talked about how Victory Slash has been playing really well, and they should target him because he's really popping off.
You spoke it into existence.
Instantly killed him.
Well, you know, and a point as well to what Vega said, the one time everybody grouped up was a big win for Revery Sparked. So...
It's the Kennen effect.
It is. Ash Arrow goes a little wide. They're going to turn back onto this Rift Herald. First Rift Herald of the series, I think, that has been picked up. Wait, was Smite just used? No.
No.
Hard to tell the animation sometime. Banana Man being isolated right there. Oh, my God. Look at this. Look at this group fight. Look at that Kennen ult as well. This is what Revery Sparked wants. This is what they dream of. This is what they need to play for. Picklehater living for a long time, but inevitably going down. And now 97 Onions. Oh. Not enough onions to escape that situation. They get the Rift Herald, but at what cost?
Gragas ulted Syndra into the Kennen ult.
Yeah, that was beautiful. Dude, this guy knows how to play Gragas. This guy knows how to play Gragas.
My concern in champ select was that Gragas can be very anti-synergistic with circle ult champions, right?
Sure.
Things like Kennen, things like Wukong. But if you're good at Gragas, and you can use the ult well, it can work just fine.
Yeah.
But I was curious to see how it went. And from that team fight alone, I am quite confident that Gabe Recall knows how to use that ult.
Yes. Very much so. Very comfortable on it. And I think we're starting to see
a lot of damage.
Yeah, I know, it's insane. We're starting to see a story develop here as we look at the patterns of the Knights Templar finding success in picks, and Revolution Resparked finding success on these team fights.
Which is how these teams are supposed to play out. This is how these comps are supposed to play out. So it means that both teams are playing to their win conditions well. Like, that's good news, honestly, for both teams. It's just who's going to execute better now.
I do think it's a real problem for the Knights Templar because eventually, I mean, there are ways to try to avoid it. Sense maybe in some trouble right there. There are ways to, you know, just like really only try to like play off of picks, try and isolate and separate the team, but at a certain point, you know, Baron, Elder, like, you do have to get together and fight. Those are going to be the fights that I cannot wait to see, because those will be when everything hinges on those engages. And by now, two times in a row, the Knights Templar know how they're losing these fights, right? So
The trick for pick comp is you want to get that pick before those fights happen. So then, like, yes, they're not going to be able to win a 5v5 team fight, but they don't ever want to take a 5v5 team fight. They want to take 5v4 team fights. They want to take 5v3 team fights. They want to be able to pick someone crucial so that they can take a team fight that's winnable by just by virtue of numbers.
Absolutely. God. What a dangerous bush right here. Banana Man, there's the pull. They go for the Tom Kench, the Scatter of the Week as well, and they're just dumping everything into him, but it's not enough. Is Kench able to survive? A flash away immediately. Banana Man, oh my God, once again. I need a highlight reel of this guy escaping with less than 10% health.
This game is full of slippy folks.
That's like the fourth time.
Slippy people.
That's the fourth time that he's walked away with essentially no health. Someone made a deal with the devil, all right?
Or just cover themselves in baby oil.
Or cover themselves in baby oil. It's so hard to tell, and I'm constantly accusing people of making deals with devils and then finding out that they've just covered themselves with baby oil, so.
I keep doing the opposite. I keep being like, man, did you cover yourself in baby oil? And they've got red eyes and horns. They're like,
dude,
no.
And that's how we balance each other out. That's really beautiful. Little doll, Ash here, a little anti-synergistic with that pull. Swift Carol's run is good for SKT because they're opting into weak side of the map. Oh, hold on. What do we see here? Is this Onions getting picked? Nope, maybe. All right, that's going to be the pull onto the Gragas, but let's see what Gragas does with the second. He flashes away. That's going to be an ult to save himself by some time and actually knocked Blitzcrank back into a charge. Wow, this is ballsy. Only a crazy man goes forward and tries to get that healing fruit after what just went down. So that's Gragas ult down. This dragon's up. Blitzcrank.
Another request for a quick gold check.
Yes, absolutely, Praetorian. No problem. Gold check right now, right before this fight. Thank you. Thank you for the heads up. Barrel thrown over the wall. Fight lines being established right here. That's going to be a pull. Who's the target? They get the cannon. They push everything into him. They're able to get him out. That's going to be one massive AoE ability. Take it off the field right there. Wukong ulting too. Pulston looking to get excited. They are excited, but the Sejuani ult misses, but the Ashe ult does not. Nails the Tom Kench, but they're not able to stop him from getting away. Maybe Braum passive. They get him in the end, but a 3-for-1, and that is the first team fight that Serenity Knights Templar is able to win, and off the back of it, they get this dragon. Now, let's look at the gold. People got money. People got money. What is that? Who's got the most money? Sense?
It is. Yes.
Sense is the most money.
Hair. Kennen's only a couple hundred gold behind.
That's true.
Sindra's got
so the fact that they were able to kill Kennen in that fight, that Koba was able to snatch him out of that crowd. Koba was able to pick him out of a lineup. He had his number right away. Pulls him in. They eliminate that Kennen immediately. And now we see, you know, that that's the second most amount of gold in the game gone from the team fight. So it seems like an underlying amendment is being added to these team fight wins. Koba going up. Let's see who he can grab right here. He's got his eyes on Pulston, knocks him up. That's going to be a Scatter of the Week. Goes across. A great Tom Kench eat from Caps. Teleport coming in right here. The amendment is just victory slash. You need victory for victory. That's it. God, Gabe recalled this dude. Fox, he knows exactly how to play Gragas. Huge Banana Man's not slippery enough to get out of that one. Massive, massive Gragas ult. Truly able to just get away with it. Oh. I mean, the guy can grog. I don't think there's
any
question
about
that.
The dude can grog. Oh! That cannon. This game is going to hinge on Kennen ults for Rev.
Absolutely. Absolutely. The guy's a terror.
Yeah.
Absolute nightmare.
The Shadow Flame was really nice. Bye from him.
Why doesn't Kennen look like this whenever I play him? That's what I want to know.
Oh, it's because you're not very good at Kennen.
Fuck. That is why. That is why. I've been ashamed to say it. A lot of damage coming out of Gragas
like
as well. Yeah. I'm so bad at Kennen. It's fucking.
It's weird. It's a weird. Yeah, Gragas. Gragas is a lot of gold. Let me do a quick gold check on Gragas. Gragas is it's a little behind. I wonder why is it gold? Oh, farm's not huge. Yeah. I mean, this Rod is almost finished stacking. He's working on a second item. He's going a real scaling build, honestly. Mm-hmm. And I'm a little. I'm excited to see what those barrels are going to look like later.
Dude, I'm here for
casks?
It.
They're not barrels, they're casks.
They are casks. That's true. You got to get your elocution
it's not
right.
The proper use of elocution.
You've got to elocution when you go to the mall.
Yep, there it is. Now you're getting it.
Dontad32, thank you so much for being the newest investor in the low budget LCS. I can't begin to imagine what of the bullshit that we were just talking about urged you to follow us, but I appreciate it.
I thought you were going to say something like, I can't even imagine how bleak your life was before this moment, and
Jesus
now here you
Christ,
are.
Dude.
Here you are, subscribed to.
What about me
LCS
would suggest that that
okay.
would be the lane that I would go?
I just was, it just felt like that's where it was going. Like, I can't believe you haven't done it before. I'm glad you've finally seen the light.
Yeah, that's not usually the angle that I go. Look at this.
Yeah.
Knights Templar taking their fates into their own hands, starting up Baron.
Wow.
This is a great play. Could be a
it's
trap.
Early.
I say great play. This could be a disaster. Let's
not
find out.
Yeah.
Not going down fast, that's for sure.
Zoning here.
Hold on, they pulled Tom Kench forward. Now they're going to turn on it. It was indeed a trap. They were ready to turn. Caps survives, though.
Uh-oh.
Gabe recall. They got to watch out. This Gragas knows exactly what's up. The Ash Arrow into him. They're going to try and, oh my god, put everything into the Ash Arrow, but that's going to be Kennen coming in as well. Look at that massive damage coming. Sense able to find his way to the back line, but not far enough as Wukong finds, isolates, and kills the Ash. Caps, okay, dropping an exhaust here, trying to go over the wall. He does get taken down.
Huge.
But at the end of the day, it looks like Ash is the only one to fall. Koba doing their best to live here. And that's a 4-for-1, very acceptable trade. Knights Templar's got to be ecstatic about that.
That was really, really smart from Knights Templar. They, at this point in the game, your biggest threat in a teamfight is going to be Kennen and Gragas fighting at the same time. Jinx has not enough items to effectively dominate a teamfight. They're helpful for cleaning up and getting resets, but they aren't going to be the main driving thrust of the damage. Gragas and Kennen are. They see that Kennen is coming from top lane. He's a little late to get to the fight. Gragas is trying to get a flank angle, but he's on wards. And they just have to pick one of them. Ash sees an opportunity, shoots an arrow right at Gragas into a Blitzcrank hook, and they're dead. That's the fight. Kennen got a great ult off. Kennen, if Gragas was alive and that Kennen...
Oh, look at this! Once again, Gabe recall with the absolutely massive ult. Not able to get that kill. Banana Man trying to do his best banana impression. He is going to get shut down.
Huge.
That
huge.
Is... Oh, look at these Hex Gates.
Hex Gates.
Look at these Hex Gates. You got to remember, they're going to get back faster than you think they are.
Yeah, I think that's probably all they get, but boy, that was nice.
Big pick.
Yeah, without that, I think you're much more demoralized, but you at least sort of get to hold your head high and say, well, we lost Baron, we got a huge shutdown on the Syndra, onto our primary carry in this comp.
100%.
Right? Because yes, these last fights, Gragas and Kennen have been doing a lot of work, and they will continue to do a ton of work, but Jinx is really who they're waiting for to come online. They only have an item and a half.
Mm-hmm. Ooh. There is some damage. Those are two pretty tanky members. And look at this, bursting down dragon, didn't even notice it, teleport coming through. Knights Templar.
Nice.
Choose Knight. To push with Baron. Which I think is the right decision. Teleport coming into the mid lane right here.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. I mean, yes, would they rather have the dragon than not?
Oh,
yes.
Look at that. I like that they went for it, though. Good dodging of the Jinx Rocket.
Yeah. But they're fine not getting that dragon. They're cool with just shoving it through with Baron.
This isn't
a winning Baron. It's because it's so early, but it is nice global gold to get. And then ideally,
they're
kind of
pulling back.
Of
hold on a second. I don't know if they've got enough members for this. Massive Wukong in the backline. Huge Gragas ult as well. Syndra gets a kill, but Kennen absolutely eating through health bars. In turn, killed in the end. Nope, actually eaten up by Tom Kench. That's going to be Tom Kench going down. Pickle Hater playing a good frontline. Massive from the banana. He's trying to get for Pulse, and he's trying to go for that Jinx. That's a flash away. Gabe recall. Maybe waiting for cooldowns, getting some damage onto Banana Man. Cobra Strike going quite low. That's going to be another kill. Such low health bars. If Jinx can get excited, that's going to be huge for Rev. Absolutely huge.
They gotta be a little careful, actually.
Look at Victory Slash. Look at Victory Slash. That's the kill.
Yeah, yeah. That was really cheeky. That's cheeky.
Dude,
that was a Pokemon battle. He's hiding in the tall grass, walked by.
That's what Pokemon would really be like. Let's be fucking real.
Yeah.
A shout out though, these games, game one, we saw Rev re-sparked with a massive gold lead. But still an extremely close match. Game two, pretty even. Right? And now game three, we're seeing Serenity Knights Templar with a big gold lead as well. But I think if game one taught us anything is that with teams like these who've got each other's number, who know how to team fight, especially with the team fighting capability on the side of Rev Respart, you should never count anything for granted. Not right now. Not this.
Not until the Nexus blows up.
Right. Absolutely. Not until elocution. Do you? Am I using it right yet?
Yeah. You've used it right every time.
All
right.
Good. Some vision wars going on. No real objectives to fight over. This is simply looking for picks, looking for wins. Koba with the steal. Oh my god, dude, I'm so bummed that we missed Polston's steal in the other game, in game two. Nobody tell him. Everyone tell him how sick his steal was. Attack him in the Discord, make sure he knows. Uh-oh, look at this. Gabriel Call, trying to find an angle. This guy, another incredible, perfect Gragas ult. Wukong, ulting to get away.
That's the cool thing about Gragas. He does a ton of damage, but he's pretty tanky. Like, he ult, I mean, picked is maybe a strong word, but he was caught out a little and really didn't do so
much. Oh my god, that's the ult. Is that the combo? The banana, man.
Lost the flash, too. That's
holy
brutal.
Shit.
That's tough for Victory Splash.
Absolutely.
A rare misplay in the series from him.
I mean,
happens there sometimes, but
right. Yeah, he got
calculating the Syndra damage.
He got Syndra ulted and Scattered of the Week and
yeah.
Hot damn. Absolutely wild. Onions just going in, just telling him he can, you know? Rocket going a little bit wide. Huge.
Wait, they missed that can.
Now Banana Man decided to back. did not.
Banana Man does whatever a banana can. And one of those things is going back to the
base. No, that's true.
It.
About a 7k gold lead here.
Yeah, I mean, this
objectives
is looking pretty good for
close.
SKT, but.
About a minute on both these objectives. Two dragons to two. I love that. I love how even that is.
It's still going to be Cloud, right? Like, I don't know if this game's going to be determined by Dragon, but sometimes I think teams feel a pressure to fight over objectives, and if one team goes to the Dragon, the other team might go to the Dragon, and then we're in fucking business.
Absolutely. Absolutely. Honestly, yeah, the shenanigans that Gragasalt can play, they just need to get...
Yeah.
Spark just needs to get that angle. Look where everybody on Knights Templar is.
They're gonna grab this on spawn. They're gonna trade Dragon for Baron.
They're gonna trade Dragon for Baron. It's a good trade. It's a good trade, but notably, Dragon is gonna be up. Well, I guess just 5 more seconds. Look at that. Hawkshot, both teams. You know, from the direction that the Hawkshot comes from, you know where everybody is. But
yeah.
This really puts Resparked in a rough spot.
It
they
looks like
decide.
Rev is, yeah, they're moving. And now they're doing either.
Oh, I don't know if they're gonna move up. They've got to move up.
They're running
they're
out of time.
Soon. They are. Baron down a half right here. Look at this Koba strike in the middle.
Looking really fucked
playing,
up.
Causing distraction. That's a pull. That's Ash Arrow. That's gonna be Sidwaniel going in as well. Flash away from Gabe Recall. Polston doing his best, but he's got so little health right now. This Jinx has to live for this
get
fight
awesome.
To
yeah.
work. And massive a zap for the slow, but that's gonna be the Syndra ult. You just can't dodge that. And now they drive a knife through the center of the base. They're gonna push down this mid lane. Nope, never mind. They're gonna wrap back around to Baron, and that is elocution.
Rev gets the dragon, loses someone, and maybe Baron. Gragas is up in 30 and has teleport, but I don't think really anyone on Rev is able to sort of distract him. So they slowed it down a little bit, but this is still inevitably going to be a Baron that goes over to Nice Templar.
I mean, Wukong's coming up. The dude. All right, that's going to be the flash forward. Holy shit, can he do this steal? Can he get it? Holy shit, red team gets it. They secure it. Wukong dies, but that was not. That was close. That was extremely close right there.
Yeah, I guess you could also contest it.
I
did not expect that.
No, but they went for it. Baron now in the pocket of Serenity, Knights, Templar. This team has had to fight back from being down a game in this series. They want this win badly. They want to move on in the playoff tournament. Koba, they're going to pull out right there. It's a 4v5. Question is, will Resparked find the angle? That's going to be an Ash Arrow Scout of the Week. I looked down at my paper. God damn it. How did I do that? Okay, Victor Splash taking so much damage. Holy shit. A good amount of damage coming out of the Gragas right there, but maybe the first time they've gone in the direction, I don't know which direction you want them going, if I'm being real.
Yeah.
Yeah, rough. Rocket. Oh, I thought that was going to steal it. Dude, Sense taking it to the face to keep Koba alive. Now the sec, they do have three drakes. They did get the dragon.
Yeah,
the spark
yeah,
is on
true.
Soul Point.
That's true.
Do you think Hex Soul, how much do you think that evens this out?
I mean, pretty well, I think. I think getting Hex Soul for Rev would be, I don't know if it would even it out, but I don't see a way back into the game without it.
For sure. Yeah, it's definitely, it definitely could become a crucial point.
It's also another step. So, if you're down like this, one way back into the game is Elder Dragon.
That's true.
If you get the soul, even if it's not a great soul, and even if you can't use it to your full to its full potential, getting Elder to spawn faster is huge. So if you're Knights Templar, you want to make sure you get the next dragon. Not necessarily because you want the stats, though they are nice, but you don't want Elder to spawn. You want to hold off as long as you can.
100%. Look at this Baron-empowered wave, though. Eating through the tower. They got two cannons here.
Oh, I thought he was going to block that. He should.
Koba. Just looking over the wall. Just wants to make it dangerous enough. I don't know that they've got enough poke to stop these cannon minions.
I don't think they get another one. There are supers in the base that Jinxes deal with, so there's a chance that they can be maybe take another one, especially with the pick from Blitzcrank, but...
Oh, the Ash Arrow, it does connect. Koba looking for an angle to pull him up. He almost finds it. That was an incredible Tom Kench.
I think he hit it.
You think he hit it? Oh, because did the...
I think Tom Kench ate it, like, at the same...
Ate his hand as well.
It looked like he hit it.
Tom Kench will eat you. That's all I gotta say about that. No, I think you're right. I do think the animation like went over a little bit there. Okay, a trap being placed. Subterfuge in the bushes here. Hawkshot being used to hunt down Resparked. They want this fight. The Knights Templar want this fight. They're looking for it. The ult does connect with the Wukong right there. Victor Slash able to find their way out. That was just a clone, though. Beautiful, beautiful use of that ability.
Nice.
60, showing that they know what is up here. 97 onions going forward. But the damage just isn't there yet for Resparked. Jinx, three items, though. Three items. Oh, this game could take an insane turn if Jinx starts getting excited in these fights.
It is their avenue back in. I mean, of course, they have, I don't know. They have a bunch of avenues back in, honestly. It's just an uphill climb for them.
It definitely
is. Alof's gonna ride on this dragon too. If they get soul, they're in business. If they don't get soul, this game gets a lot harder for them.
The question is, I can also see the opposite of like, is it worth it? If they go for it and they die, I mean, that's...
They kind of have to though. Like, I don't really think they can win without it.
Well, they can play for the scaling, right? They can play for Pulsed and they can be like, hey,
It's hard.
There's
though,
a
man.
Lot of engaged. Like, Sejuani, 97 onions getting right up there in their face. Same with Koba. They've got like three front lines on the side of Knights Templar. That's the pull. The pull goes wide. Jinx traps are down as well. 97 onions trying to find a way onto Pulsar right here. Rocket's coming out, but look at this massive cannon ult as well.
Sejuani's
hold on. Health bar's falling. Jesus, that's massive. Dub and Animan going low as well. Koba goes down. That's an excited Jinx right now as well. Pulston getting up there. Letting those rockets hail down, and actually, this is a rout. This is an absolute rout. This is it. That was Resparked, able to win that fight, and now take this dragon, and that is Hextech Soul. This is what they needed. This is how they can get back into this game. Even with these victories, they're still down in gold. But wait a second, Pickle Hitter wasn't there.
The soul was huge, but I never, I thought they might be able to grab the soul, but. Never did I consider the idea that they might just take a 5 for nothing.
That was, it wasn't a 5 for nothing because Pickle Hater's out here. Yeah. Where was Pickle Hater during that fight? Maybe he was there and he went on the inside? I missed something. I'm missing something crucial.
That might be a fairly enormous turning point.
It truly might be. That was a huge amount of gold. Coming into their pockets. but still down 68. Pulling the Tom Kench over the wall sense here. Looking at that kiting, but that's going to be a double knockup. Onion showing up as well. A flash away. Jinx Rocket connects. But more reinforcements. Oh. Look at that. The Ash Arrow, but that's not a Jinx Rocket. That's not going to deal enough damage. But now they're fighting in this choke point. Front to back. Wukong, hold on. That's massive. Scatter the weak. Can they get the kill? Hold on. Wait a second. Look at that. That's massive. Oh, Kennen cutting through the back line. He does die in the end, but he takes the Ash out. 97 Onions. All these people. This game has been filled with people living with incredibly low amounts of health. Gragas.
Yeah.
With the blast cone, gets pushed over the wall. And now it's Respark. It's Rev Respark.
We are firmly in the this is anyone's game territory now.
100%. This is absolutely turning into a fist fight. Well said. Dub Banana Man. Dealing a lot of damage. But look at how quickly this Baron is
running. Is coming.
I don't even think they know that it was being done.
I think they did, but they're just.
They probably die. I see those words. Oh my god. Oh my god. Rev,
yeah.
Regaining momentum. This series looking like it was going to slip out of their grasp, and then they come back with two massive, massive plays. Fight win into a dragon, into a Baron take. I mean, a 4K gold lead for the side of Serenity Knights Templar. But even the Knights Templar have shown us gold lead doesn't have to necessarily mean anything. And especially when we start to get into these minutes of the game. 38 and a half minutes deep. At a certain point, gold doesn't mean shit. Nice, Ash Arrow. Oh my god, it connects on Pulsen. That's the 20 ult over the wall. That's Koba grabbing the Jinx right there. He's going for the kill. 60 though, such low health. Victory Slash coming in as well. Kennen ult, two down for the side of Revery Sparked. Two and two.
Still anyone's
back
fight.
To a 3v3. My brain shut off. Holy shit. What a fucking massive engage right there. That Ash Arrow.
Gragas is ult. Keep an eye on that. He can E forward and ult the Ash.
That's true. Sense. Has to back
he
up.
Wants it. He wants it.
Has
wants
to
it.
Find safety. And Banana Man low
He can
enough.
Also try to use it to execute Syndra. If he can get a Q on a Syndra, then he can just ult her and probably kill her.
100%. Trying times, dire moments. I don't think it's too inflammatory to say these are the last minutes of the game.
No.
Probably.
It is.
It's back and forth, using the Baron. Another Ash Arrow. That's gonna be on super low cooldown, that's right.
Yeah, I mean, it's already taking like a second's hand.
God damn. Okay. Taking out Scuttle. God, this is just all on a razor's edge.
Yeah,
they decided to stop fighting after that fight, which was the smart thing to do. I understand why Rev got scared there. They wanted to make use of their Baron. Unable to break the base, but things have evened out for them. Things have evened out for Resparked. Knights Templar, I mean, I genuinely don't know how much gold value the soul is bringing. I'm tempted to say that these teams are relatively just even now. And it's just gonna come down to execution. Gosh, little Onions maybe a little underleveled right here.
Oh, a little.
Traps going down as well, getting caught. Ash Arrow thrown forward too, but that is a tanky Sejuani. Koba backing up, looking for targets right here. As are the many engage tools of both teams. Who will strike first? You've got to take your pick. Is it the Gragas knocking you into position? Is it the Tom Kench diving in for a knockup? Is it Wukong going invisible, showing up in your back line, knocking your entire goddamn team up? It's
Kennen flanking you from the side with no vision.
Or Kennen flanking you from the side. Or is it Sejuani ult, Ash Arrow, the Scatter the Weak, or Koba pulling you in just for
game's
a little hug?
This game's popping off. Hextech Soul is helpful as well. Let's not forget that they've got that.
Absolutely.
Elder spawning in 40 seconds. Whoever gets Elder wins the game. And like,
That's a bold thing to say, but let me also say this. In the playoffs of last season, you and I casted a game. Ash Arrow? Oh, look at this teleport. Look at this deep teleport. They're trying to get Pulsen, but he flashes over the wall.
Down.
Sense is isolated.
Oh, you went to the wave. Okay.
You and I both casted a game where the team with Elder lost the game. Scatter the weak onto the Kennen. He goes golden, trying to buy time for his team, but I don't know if it's going to be enough. A flash away, but Sense is here with the auto attacks. And look at this, they just collapse on the other side of the team. Massive Wukong ult knocking everybody up. Sense trying to find his way to position. Koba gets taken down. Onion's quite low as well. That's going to be a Grog assault. So much damage, but it's not enough. That's an... Oh, the Syndra ult did not kill the Grogus. Dub Banana Man had the wherewithal to tag it, to throw it out, but it wasn't enough. And now...
That's going to be an Elder for Rev.
It's a one.
I think. Picklemator coming.
Running in. Ash here too. The teleport coming down. Oh boy. Oh baby. They're going to turn on to the Olaf right here. Sense trying to get these autos down, taking so much damage. Ash goes golden, trying to buy some time for the front line to show up. But look who's there. Look who's back. It's the Gragas. He came back. He found the back line. Massive damage. Jinx excited. That is the full fucking ace right there. A triple kill for Jinx. And Red 3 sparked. Gets the win. They're going to go for the end. Blitzcrank is going to come back up. I don't think he can hold the base. That's massive. That's a massive fight for them.
Grog's ult is back up
again
already.
Holy shit, they were down earlier in this game.
Wild.
In this very game, they were behind.
The gold dead even.
The gold was dead even. Now they're ahead. Wow. They've got the Hex Soul. Can Koba hold them back? Holy shit, he finds Jinx out of that whole crowd. Picks him out of a lineup. Hold on, he's not dead. He's got to clear the wave if he's going to do anything at all. Gabriel going to get knocked up. Going to stop the auto attack for just a second. Another pull right there, but that's Blitzcrank out of the picture. Holy shit, I think they did it. Referee Sparked takes the series and moves on to the next round of playoffs in the Commercial League.
Upset. Huge upset. Well played to them.
What?
Hashtag Rev Up.
Hashtag Rev Up. They did it. They did it. They came back, and from a difficult place too. An extremely difficult place. Look at the damage charts. You've got Pulsen on that Jinx high up there. You've got Kennen as well. But Dub Banana.
That was a great series.
That was such a good series. That was such
both
a good
these
series.
Teams played so well.
I know. I know you've stayed up late for this. So if you need to go to sleep, go to sleep.
I am going to go to sleep.
All right. Goodbye.
But that was a wonderful series. Congratulations to both teams for a well-played series. But congratulations to Rev for moving on to the next round.
Hell yeah. We're going to see if we can get somebody in for a quick interview because I'm also a sleepy little boy. But if... Oh, no. Oh, no. Did it? It's stuttering. Okay, we're good. Holy shit. My computer stopped. It had a heart attack. Let's see. Let's see. Hold on. At Rev. Rev Sparked. Send someone for an interview if you want. Just one person.
All right.
Dude, yes. Wait, who is this?
Dude, this is Praetorian.
Praetorian. Fuck yeah. All right.
No. Okay, let's. This is the shout out to everyone who's watching. We got 110 viewers.
Dude, yes.
LBLCS watch parties are going to be a staple. That call got so hyped.
Dude, right. You got that.
Who's up here for interview?
Yeah, dude. Well, fucking, hold on. Stay on for this. Stay on for this interview.
Yeah. I'll pull. Let's see. I might get an interview. Someone
just bring
else.
One person because it's a nightmare. They need
Less
to pick a
champion. I'm dragging you in here because you're better at this than I am.
All right. Let's see. Hold on. At Rev.
Prompt you on the cast.
At Rev. Hold on. Rev Sparked. Tag me who it is. Dude, what a fucking wild. What a wild series.
Incredible. Absolutely.
There was a lot of great series tonight.
Hold on, it's Gabe Recall. We've got our man.
He's the Gragas player.
He was the Gragas player. He's their mid laner.
I'll grab
Gabe
him.
Gabe Recall. Okay, you grab him. You grab him.
Hello.
Beautiful. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the desk. Gabe Recall, congratulations on an incredible series, my guy. Let's start at the end, where all good stories start. That Gragas, you clearly play the champion, right?
Never in mid lane. I'm
shut the
honest.
Fuck up, dude.
This is,
no way.
This is something I'm always playing in jungle.
No way.
I played it I think this is my fifth mid game on it, and like one scrim.
Dude, what?
Yeah.
That's nuts. So what persuaded you in the draft to say, Gragas, I know it. It's the one.
I mean, so going after game two, we had a few teamfight struggles. So we just said we're going to go full on engage. And then it came around to the round two picks, and he picked Syndra on the fourth pick.
Mm-hmm.
And I knew that there was no, it was either going to be me picking Gragas mid or Malphite mid, because neither one Syndra can, like, you know, dodge. As soon as I get sick, she's going to die whenever I'm focused on her. So,
I mean, you crushed it. By the way, Les Force, feel free to talk over me at any point if you have any questions.
Dude, we were literally screaming our heads off there at the end of that game three. Like, that, what, there's like 30 people in there. Like, the whole series was so phenomenal. Absolutely loved the Gragas mid. Loved, like, the Tahm Kench support, so effing smart into, like, what they wanted to play. So shout out to whoever's idea that was. But, like, oh my god, that was, like, I know I just said that High Alert vs. Serenity was the best series I've ever watched, you know, 4 days ago. But I think you guys have already topped that, man. This is an awesome playoff so far.
Yeah, dude, this is definitely the craziest best of three I've ever played. But the Tahm Kench was another, like, role swap. We just figured it out this week. We're figuring it out, so.
Now, okay, who is, because you guys are lower seeded. You guys were the lower seed coming into this, right?
Yes.
Okay, beautiful. First of all, I love a Cinderella story. Azebra's already talking about it in the Discord. You guys have a ton of fans out there. Lots of people saying, hashtag rev up. You guys have a lot of support. Just so you know that. I don't know if you've had a chance to look at Twitch chat. But who's doing the shot calling? How have you guys come together as a team? Like, how'd you guys find each other? Is this a group of friends? Is this people who found each other through the Discord? What's the culmination to bring you to this victory today?
So it's actually a pretty long history for a few. Me, Sethi in the jungle, and Polston on ADC, we've been teaming for, I think, 3 or 4 seasons in a row now. And then I met Drake, the top laner, Victory Slash. I met him through a college esports team. So we all go to the same college. And then we brought on the support because it's Sethi, our jungle's friend. So
that's awesome. And how was your regular season? Like, coming into these playoffs, what were your expectations?
You know, the regular season was really rough. We had a lot of position struggles where we couldn't figure out what our right style was. The meta was changing away from how we were playing at the beginning of the season. And then we had some like outside of the game issues with our team. Once we got our newest support onto the team, we really solidified our team fighting. And I think that's really what brought us towards the big finish. Like, the last 3 weeks, I think we had 2-3 game series that we lost, nail biters, and then we ended it on like a fiery 2-0 that brought us going into playoffs. So we were coming in with a lot of heat. We had a lot of struggles at the beginning, but I think we're really moving, you know, the rocket don't stop.
That is amazing, dude. Well, I am so excited to see you guys continue through this playoffs. You probably don't even know who you're playing next, but anything else you want to say about the rest of the playoff coming up, a playoff tournament coming up, anything about the team, any last words before we let you go?
I think my biggest thing is, you know, I was the one to get chosen to talk here, not because I'm the best player. I hope that's not askewed for anyone that was watching the stream. I'm shouting out my teammates here. There's a lot of lower points that weren't streamed. They're my teammates carried me, so I hope everybody that's watching the stream realizes that my team is still crazy. And then I also want to shout out the people in the Revolution Esports server that were watching our series. I know they were in the stream, so thank you guys.
Love the humility.
Hell yeah. Also, please convey my personal apologies to Polston. The stream cuts out for the literal second that he steals Dragon with Jinx ult. Anyways, just my bad. some shit happened. There's a spectator bug. When the game ends, the screen flickers off for 3 minutes beforehand. It's whatever. It's Riot's fault. It's not my fault. Listen, dude, congrats again. Thank you so much. We will see you as you guys, and you know, we'll watch your rise through the playoff tournament. And have a wonderful rest of your night, man.
Hey, thanks, guys. Thanks for casting and streaming our game.
Absolutely. All right, folks, we've done it again. We are going to raid someone, because why not? But just want to say thank you so much again. Once again, my brain's falling apart right now. This is the Low Budget LCS. My name is LeChance. Tonight I was joined by Bigfoot, also Praetorian, also Lestforce, all wonderful people. And you can catch more of this stuff in the coming weeks very soon, because we're in the middle of our playoffs tournament. We got Discord down below. We got YouTube. There are other buttons to press. Anywho, thank you all so much for tuning in. We are going to raid a friend of the channel, because there are no leagues running right now. This person has raided us a bunch. It's Itty Bitty Banshee. Very cool person, is playing Age of Wonders 4, which is a fucking awesome game. So go say hi. And yeah, Lestforce, anything you want to say?
I'm just glad that, you know, I'm glad to say, if anyone saw the article, I said hop on the Rev Party Bus while you could. And I think I got a few people to hop on with me. The seats are crowding up a little bit. But no, absolutely just phenomenal from both teams. Can't say enough good things about either squad.
Hell awesome yeah. Series. Star journalist Lestforce. All right, folks.